All right, there we go. Live, and I think we're up to session 6. I think. So yes, session 6 of our foyer into Pathfinder. Last time we played, you guys had tried to negotiate with the gremlins. Ran into a slight problem in that you couldn't actually communicate with them.
And they were very unreasonable.
Well, maybe. Things went well up until they didn't. Up until you discovered that they had a kobold prisoner that they were torturing to death. And Father Hull decided that he couldn't abide that. Combat broke out with some gremlins and their centipede minion. Managed to pull through that, although some people did get injured in the process. But while that fight was happening, the Gremlin King and some of his cohorts escaped through a back door out of their burrow back to the surface. And when you guys got up there, you realized that they had, in a kind of spiteful manner, released your horses. No sign of the horses being injured or killed, just released. But you did find out that there is apparently a war of some nature between the gremlins and some nearby kobolds. Aggression back and forth, a lot of dead on both sides. And the ring that you're trying to find, Svetlana's wedding ring, that the bandits took, was stolen from the bandits by the gremlins and then stolen from the gremlins by the kobolds. You also found a small stone idol of some sort of winged horned figure that the kobold prisoner was interested in retrieving for his king before he was put out of his misery by Snow Maple. So with that in hand, you think that, okay, maybe the kobolds will at least be open to reason. We have this thing that they've been trying to get. We've killed some of their enemies. Maybe we can reason with the kobolds.
We can speak their language.
You can speak their language. You know from a little battle map that was in the Gremlin situation room, for lack of a better term, that the kobolds are... Basically, their home is in a nearby mine a little bit to the southeast of where you currently are. I should actually put that on the map.
Are we able to get our horses back?
You can definitely try. You know that they haven't had that long to run, and they are trained horses. They're not just wild horses that you have found. So between Traxon and Father Hull, you guys can easily track down the horses if you wish. It's just going to take some time.
Well, I imagine we want to get the horses back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They nice. Speed things up, and they were very expensive.
Yeah. I'd like to see Henry again. I like him.
Oh. So sorry.
Want to find glue.
It'll be sad someday. I know. Maybe today.
I'm sure we can find him.
It's a very promising looking structure.
Promising, ominous.
Right. So the kobolds are a little bit to the southeast of you. It'll take a little bit of time to get there, and it is getting on towards evening now.
Well, let's see if we can find the horses before dark.
Yep.
Alright. Why doesn't either Father Hull or Traxton give me a tracking type roll?
I think you're better now, aren't you? I'm +9 survival.
I might be, because I do have goggles that do tracking specifically.
And then you get expert in survival, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, it brings tracks in, but basically at this point you guys are equal.
Okay.
I mean, let's have the Ranger do Ranger things.
I rolled a 14.
Oh, nice.
Strap on the green goggles and we'll head out.
Alright, so you know, strap on the goggles, kind of, you know, click through a couple of lenses, I imagine, goes through like a couple of different things to kind of zoom in.
Horso vision engaged.
Yeah.
You pick up a couple of things because you didn't quite get a critical success, but the horses ran together. They didn't go in a bunch of different directions. Because horses are herd animals and you do have two trained war horses.
Right.
So those two kind of like herded the rest. And you find them not terribly far off. Like, takes you guys maybe an hour or so to track them down, but given the speed at which horses move, they didn't run for very long. To Traxton, to your kind of ranger-ness, you would assume that they ran far enough to get away from the threat, from the creatures that, you know, scared them. But then they just kind of stopped and waited. You know, find them grazing on some grasses and wildflowers and stuff.
Gotcha. Okay. Well, I'll call out not to spook them and start moving towards them. I imagine mine and at least probably Father Hull's horse recognize me. Probably immediately.
Yep, and they just kind of like they look at you, you know, chewing on their grasses. You know, just kind of like, hey, how's it going?
Good boys, good boys.
What time you caught up?
Yeah, real slow. Come up to the two war horses and just sort of pat them down a little bit and start tying everybody together. I imagine they probably weren't to begin with. It was these guys that kept them all together only, basically. So I'll just start real slowly sort of chaining them together.
You can get them together easy enough. I mean, now that there's nothing, you know, deliberately frightening them, even the riding horses are relatively docile.
Right. It doesn't look like they were, as I'm doing this, it doesn't look like they were hurt at all by the scattering, were they? Like, were they stabbed or anything to get them moving?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's scary.
Yeah, just basically, you know, kind of like, go on, get, sort of thing.
Yeah. They did have a horrible giant bug with them, too, so probably.
Yep.
Gotcha. Okay. I'll bring them on back.
What was it, some kind of giant tick or something?
Giant tick.
I can only imagine how big that was after seeing the giant, quote, giant centipede.
Dog size, right?
Yeah, the giant tick was a medium creature, so it was like the size of like a mastiff.
Right.
I don't trust it.
It's a big tick.
That is a very big tick.
Disturbing enough, yep.
It was a very big centipede.
It was.
I mean, at least you'll notice if it bites you.
True.
I think I just caught the tail, and that was enough for me.
It fully put me down. That wasn't pleasant.
I fixed you up.
You did.
Buffed out the dents.
I think our biggest problem is getting across the river.
There was a crossing a ways back.
Yep.
And for one side, but looks like we're crossing again.
Right.
We'll have to see what we can see, I guess.
Yep. So are you guys traveling on through the evening, or are you going to set up a little camp here and make out in the morning?
Might as well start out fresh, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Camp here. try to get a place where we can see that big tree. Not that you can't really see it, but
yeah, you can see this tree. I mean, as the sun starts to drop, it does get harder and harder to make out, but it's visible from miles away.
Right.
All right. So somebody can give me a survival roll to find a suitable spot for a camp.
Go for it, Trex.
Oh, sorry. Sure. I was going to say you've been doing it up to this point, and we're still neck and neck. So.
Okay. Well, I can roll it if you want.
Cut you late.
Yep. You've been doing all right up to this point, I think.
Ah, you cursed it.
Uh-oh.
12.
All right.
So you do find a spot, but it's going to be rough camping tonight. Basically, any of your campsite activities that you want to do, like cooking, finding ingredients, organizing watches, all that sort of thing, are at a -2 penalty.
Gotcha.
It's probably wet.
It's a little wet. It's rocky. There's a fair number of like centipedes and spiders, not giant ones by any stretch, but there's enough that, you know, just when you think like you find a good spot to lay down your bedroll, you know, they start like, you know, kind of, you get that little feeling of like little legs on your skin. You're like, oh shit. It's just genuinely not a great campsite. But it is a campsite. Does anybody wish to camouflage it?
What do you think, guys?
Oh, it doesn't hurt to try.
Sure.
All right. That's a stealth roll, is it?
Stealth roll at -2. Oh, nice. So it is a success. Does anybody, are you guys just going to eat rations or is somebody going to cook?
I think our cook is otherwise engaged. Unless anybody else wants to take a stab at it.
Sure. Does anyone know how to cook?
That's a specific skill, isn't it? I think I know one recipe.
It's a survival or cooking lore.
Okay.
Or if nobody wants to cook, you can just eat rations.
Right.
My survival's only +2.
I have a decent survival. Yeah.
Whip up some eggs and fry bologna.
Mine's a 7, but it's not as good as our ranger or the father.
I think the ranger wanted to learn a recipe this time. I mean, I could try to cook if you want me to.
I just got a +1. It's not me.
I don't know what we have for ingredients.
We have 18 basic ingredients and 9 specials.
Okay.
So you can cook a basic meal at any rate. Does anybody wish to hunt and gather?
So that's a question I've got. Well, tangentially, I guess. I do want to try and learn the haggis recipe, but is that my action? Like, can I also do tracking?
No. It takes you the whole time for the professor to kind of go through haggis for you.
Gotcha. That's what I was thinking. I just wanted to check. Okay.
24 on the cooking. It's not bad.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Perfect. All right. So Traxon's going to learn haggis. Does anybody want to organize the watches? You need to be at least an expert in perception, which I think everybody is at this point.
Oh.
Actually, Moot Pint is not.
Moot Pint is not what?
You're still only trained in perception. You're not an expert at perception.
No.
But Flower is, if you would like to organize watches.
Sure.
All right. Perfect. Moot point. Basically, you could help somebody do a thing, you could just relax, or you could tell a campfire story if you like. And I'm going to say, like, as we kind of discussed about, like, the interludes and a chance to bring your character, kind of, elements of your character into play, we'll just kind of file that under tell campfire story during, like, camping, or if there's, like, a lull while you guys are traveling and you want to, like, interject something about your character, we'll do it that way. So, what would Moot Point like to do?
Moot, I guess why does he tell a campfire story?
All right, perfect.
What do I roll for that?
It is performance, and also you can tell a story. Tell us a little bit about Moot Point, or at least the sort of story he tells.
He'll probably just tell a fairy tale, a love story or something, about an elf named... Finn, who fell in love with a dired and named him you, and unfortunately, time after time, he finds her and loses her as throughout the centuries, as he gets mind wiped repeatedly by, usually by the queen of the elves, queen of the fairies, who's just likes to play with the poor sod. To this day, they are still searching for each other and never finding each other. There, a little sad love story.
Right. Story was sad as hell.
I'd just like to reiterate that elves are not fae.
Yeah, the elves are very much not fae.
Aliens.
That story needs superheroes.
Maybe in the future centuries.
All right, Trexton can give me a perception check to see if he picks up the haggis recipe.
Alrighty.
Meal of Champions.
Yeah. I rolled a 9, so probably not this time.
No, every time, like, the professor is going through it and, you know, you guys are swatting at mosquitoes and, you know, various other, you know, like, uncomfortable pests, and you just can't seem to concentrate and focus. It probably doesn't help that the professor is probably explaining this in very, like, kind of, like, long-winded technical terms as opposed to, you know, meeting the audience where they are.
Right.
He's definitely a professor. That does not necessarily mean he's a good instructor.
No, he uses all the big words. Yeah. I don't know many of those. Not yet, anyway.
Flower can give me a perception check at -2.
Yes. Take 2 off of this. 21.
Excellent. So you managed to get everybody kind of organized, you know, make sure that when people are on a watch, you know, you kind of scout out the campsite, you're like, okay, you know, these are kind of avenues of approach that anything might use. So it does mean that everybody will have a +1 bonus on perception checks during your shift while you're on watch.
This is a fortifiable position right here. Stand here.
Stand here, look in this direction.
Look that way.
Perfect. The big advantage to organized watch is if you get a critical success, the party size is treated as if it was larger for how long it actually takes you to rest. So it actually cuts down on how much time you need to rest overall for everybody to get their 8 hours.
Nice.
So, sort of important if you're, like, under a time crunch. But other than that, Father Hull, he already rolled. So everybody gets a +1 bonus on any saving throws until the morning.
I mean, it's not haggis, but it's good.
It does take 1 ration and 2 basic ingredients per serving.
You got all that done?
Yeah. So are we 10 or 12?
We'll say 10.
Okay.
We'll say the professor will just eat his rations. He's busy trying to teach haggis cooking. He doesn't have time to...
In that case, we're down to 8 basic ingredients.
But night passes without incident because the Game Master apparently still cannot roll random encounters. But you get up in the morning, it's wet, it's drizzly. Your campsite is a little bit soggin, a little bit, a little bit underwater. The place that you found was kind of in a little gully. So you wake up and, your bedrolls are like in an inch of water and it's starting to soak into your sleeping bags. It's just kind of a miserable way to start the day.
Well, better start a fire, dry everything out before we leave.
True.
Or at least try to.
Oh, that's easy enough. Traxton will just, wherever we've had the fire, and he'll just hold his hand in there for as long as it takes. He'll just whisper a few words in Druidic, and his hand will burst into flame.
All right.
And he'll just hold it in there till, like I say, till the wood catches, because it, I can use it as a light source, just continually holding on to it if I want to. So.
We'll pour some more kindling onto your hand.
Yep. Probably not directly on, maybe to the side or whatever, but yeah, he'll use it to light the fire.
Yep. And that's something important to point out for those of you who are spellcasters, is now that you guys are third level, all of your spells are, all of your cantrips are automatically heightened to second level.
Hell yeah.
Ooh.
So they either heal more or deal more damage, etc. For Moot Point, that includes the cantrip that's in your staff.
Sweet.
Those of you who are spellcasters can figure out your spells. Everybody can hit the rest button to get a little bit of healing in. Replenish spell slots.
I'm happy with my spells. So I got them, I think. Actually, we don't have prof, so I'm going to get rid of Magic Stone.
Oh, good. My spell slots are restored.
All of them, even.
Yeah.
Same.
No, you just awaken well rested.
Less pissed off than I was the day before.
Yeah. It's because in Snow Maple's case, it's your hat of disguise that is refreshed.
Yeah, I know.
But kind of a wet, cloudy day. It's the 11th of Frost, so it's basically only the 11th of March-ish in the conventional weather. You guys can decide which direction you'd like to go. And yes, crossing the river may be an issue. For those of you who are trained in survival or nature, it's not raining nearly hard enough to worry about, like, flash floods or the river swelling or anything of that nature. So the crossing that you found previously will definitely still function. You don't know if there's one that gets you to where you need to go. You may have to actually hunt around to find a ford.
Okay.
Well, let's see if we can find another crossing then.
Yep. Absolutely. Or at least somewhere to make it a little easier.
So which direction would you like to go?
I guess southeast towards the structure there. Yeah.
Okay. All right, perfect. And I will get whoever is kind of leading to give me a survival roll.
Okay, dibs this time.
That's you, yeah.
I'll keep watch with the scope.
Okay.
Oh, this is real good. That's a nat 20.
Ooh, nice. So critical success.
I hope so.
A couple of things. As you hunt around, you do find there's like a little, it's not quite a ford, but it's a place where the river is shallower. Definitely fordable. You wouldn't want to cross it if the rains were heavier by any stretch, but you do find one that leads directly from where you are into the area where the kobolds are.
Okay.
And then I'll get Snow Maple to give me a perception roll.
Nice job, Draxon. Oof.
Oof.
Two crits.
Also, we're seeing stuff.
Perfect. So even with the rain, which would increase the DC, that is still exceptional. So you're kind of keeping your eye open as this Draxon goes on. You guys are riding your horses, that kind of slow, kind of a canter, I guess, is the slower trot. But Snow Maple. You do spot a couple of things. Basically, to your northeast. Here.
Okay.
Yeah, because a critical success, I give you two hexes.
Oh, fancy.
So you don't have to pick which one you're looking at. So up there, you spot a kind of a gnarly looking tree. Its branches, it kind of stands out. It's not as large as the sycamore, but these are largely grasslands, so any kind of medium large tree does tend to stand out. And that one is looks like it has been struck by lightning.
Oh, a lightning struck tree.
So it looks eerily like a claw that's kind of reaching up.
That might be magically interesting, wouldn't it, for like magic folk?
It's entirely possible.
I'd like to know if it's still alive.
And then directly to your east, you find there's like a little kind of raggedy looking rope bridge across the river with a little shack beside it.
Oh.
But with a critical success, it looks like the shack is in disrepair, as is the bridge. But it's definitely fordable at that point.
Gotcha. So we'll make a note of that for future public works.
Well, yeah, Flowers, you gotta have a lot of work to do.
Yeah, put that on Flowers' to-do list.
It's what, the second bridge?
Yeah, second uh-huh. bridge.
Yeah.
First one was super rickety.
Yeah.
This one's just a little rickety.
Just a touch.
So you do know that there is a ford in that place as well.
So it's ford and rickety bridge with adjoining cabin? Question mark.
Yep.
And the other one is lightning struck tree of bigness.
Yep.
All right.
Isn't there supposed to be a witch around here somewhere, or a hag?
Yeah,
that'd be a great place for a hag.
It's on the lakeshore.
Yeah, on the shores of the Tuskwater.
Right.
Oh, that's nowhere near then.
Oh, gotcha. So not the hag.
No. Probably not.
Well, should we go evict some kobolds?
No, we want to make friends with. We're going to try. We're going to try to make friends with the kobolds.
I mean, everything we know about kobolds is they're malicious, evil, stealing little creatures.
Yes. But maybe these ones could be our evil, malicious, stealing little creatures.
Okay. I mean, we could try it that way.
I'd like to at least make friends with some of the nobles, the locals.
But they're all bad. None of them are nice. Maybe we can find, elves or halflings.
Well, maybe these ones are a little nicer. They've been at war with the gremlins for a while. Maybe they're ready to explore peace.
Do have a common, in quotations, foe.
See? Flower gets it.
I used the word quotations.
No, I understand. It was good job.
Okay, good. I used that right.
Yeah, you did it.
Gives like a thumbs up.
Thumbs up, big guy. Good job. I mean, he could have said semicolon. We still would give him thumbs up.
Parentheses.
Points for effort. That's the main thing.
Word. He doesn't use them often.
All right. So, your idea is you want to negotiate with the kobolds.
I mean, we can give it a try. What's the worst it could have?
The same thing that just happened yesterday?
Well, they probably don't have a giant friggin' centipede monster.
I want a pet lizard person.
It did almost work. From what I heard.
The torture started.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, they have to be half civilized.
I fixed that part.
Yeah.
It didn't go well after that, but I fixed it.
Well, you ended it.
Yeah. I tried many other things first. I worked at it for a while. I was committed.
There was effort.
This plan is the same plan as we had last time.
Mm-hmm.
This time we can speak their language. Can communicate.
Yeah, I've been working on it. I picked up a scrap of Draconic here and there.
Initial hostility could be wasteful. That's I like that approach.
Okay. Whatever you think's best.
Alright, so you guys are headed directly there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I see it. It wouldn't hurt to try. We've dealt with kobolds before, so there's nothing saying we can't just deal with them the same way if things go south anyway.
I mean, watch out for traps.
Yes. Murder holes.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And they do like getting around, on either side of you. At least the last ones did.
Hmm.
So you guys strike out, heading across the river, and yeah, the water here it's a fast current, but it's shallow enough that it's not in any danger of sweeping anybody other than maybe the professor away, maybe Moot Point. But you guys can just put them up on the horses easy enough.
Do we know if kobolds swim? Are they known to be swimmers?
To make a recall knowledge.
Ooh, yeah.
That being the case, he probably doesn't like it, so, but I'll carry Gretch across because he might get swept away too.
Okay. Alright. You're really not sure. The extent of what you can recall about kobolds is pretty much what you guys have just kind of run down.
Gotcha. Well, we still have their fancy statue, so that's a good hold card.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's one of those things. I mean, they are humanoid-ish. Some of them can probably swim, but you've never heard of, like, oh yes, the kobolds are aquatic creatures that can hold their breath for 10 hours.
Yeah, they're not renowned swimmers.
Right.
Legend has it, some of them might have wings.
That's possible. Maybe. Maybe they can fly underwater. You guys don't know.
That'd be cool.
Like penguins.
Yeah, that's cool, penguins.
Yeah.
Laura's never seen a penguin, so he's picturing like a whale-sized penguin.
Terrible predator.
Absolutely.
Scourge the north.
Yeah. No sense of scale or anything, just like...
No.
That's a little penguin.
Orca, penguin, who knows?
Leopard penguins.
Mm-hmm.
They're black and white and ferocious.
Exactly.
Deadly.
Right. But as you guys make your way through these grasslands, you know, there's some sporadic trees here and there, little copses of trees periodically, kind of keeping your eye open. But the wet weather seems to be keeping people at bay. Thanks to Moot Point and the professor, you guys do have a rough approximation as to where this kobold encampment might be from the war map that they saw. And before too long, you find an outcropping of like several large boulders near a hill. You can kind of make out a narrow opening in the rocks, and there's a fallen sign that you can barely make out. You can't make out the words on the sign. You can make out the presence of the sign through the rain near the side of the cave entrance. And outside the cave, there is a little, like, cage made of branches and sticks.
Is it empty?
Give me a perception roll.
Or is there a little gray man inside it?
Oof.
We're just all perception all the time today.
That's three crits in a row.
Holy crow.
All right.
Combat's going to be so bad.
All going to die.
That's right.
All right. So as you kind of peer through the rain, you know, and the cold white rain is like dripping off the tips of your ears and off your nose.
Ugh.
And you kind of peer, and two things draw your attention. There is a small blue-skinned creature in the cage. Looks wet and miserable, and looks very much like the gremlins that you guys dealt with yesterday. And just inside the cave entrance, kind of like staying out of the rain, there is a kobold who's basically kind of like walking back and forth in front of the cave entrance with a spear.
Okay.
Well, Snow Maple, I mean, it's your plan, so.
Yeah, I mean, they've got a little gremlin guy in the cage there. But they're not actively torturing him. So.
Well, I'm not averse to prisons.
Ah, excellent. All right, good. I just wanted to get that out of the way first before we got into it.
Quite fond of prisons, actually.
Oh, okay.
Rehabilitation is very important.
Good to know.
Maybe they're a little more lawful than the gremlins.
Yeah, head towards the sentry and try to get his attention from a distance in a non-violent way.
All right. So as you kind of like stride forth, you see he basically kind of like steps forward with this spear out, and in Draconic, he's like, "Who? Big ones? Not supposed to be big ones."
Hello, friend. I'll say in Draconic.
He kind of like looks at you, like he's holding his spear down, but he has it semi-relaxed?
We have done battle with your enemies. And I'll point to the Grumma.
And he seems to be kind of taking a look. Kind of, he comes out of the cave a little bit. It's like,
and I'll wave a hand back to my allies and be like, "We are now the rightful overlords of these lands, and we wish to form an alliance with you."
Chief Sootscale is our leader, not you.
That is correct, and that will remain correct. And I'll just wave like all away, like all behind us, like we are overlords of this land.
Give me a diplomacy roll.
Or deception. We're not actually lords of this land yet.
Oh no, we have a writ. We're totally overlords.
We have a writ to hang bandits. That's all we have right now.
Yeah.
Haven't got that second writ yet. I think we got to kill the stag lord, right?
Yes. Yeah, well, okay, fine.
We're gonna be the overlords of this land.
Yeah.
Is it a lie then, Chris?
No, I'd say this is still diplomacy.
Yeah.
They're both pretty good.
It's our plan.
Oh. I could hero point it. Maybe it'll get better.
Keep it going.
There you go.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. All right.
This little kobold, and as you go closer, you see like he's the only guard.
Yeah,
he's like all by himself. It's like
short help is better than no help.
Like, you should talk to Chief Sutsko.
Excellent.
Follow me.
It's not a small cave, is it? Or is it a small cave?
One sec. It is not a small cave.
Holy crap, it's a huge cave.
Nope.
Yep. So he motions you in. Is everybody else catching up, or are you sending some people in by yourself?
I think we'll tie up the horses, at least all will, and follow along.
Get out of the rain.
Okay. I'll join.
Yeah, the professor will say, like, I'll watch the horses so they don't run away this time.
It's probably a good idea, honestly.
Yeah, Traxton will definitely hustle up there.
Okay. Alright, so the first thing this little kobold does, he's like, oh, more friends. My name is Knackpick.
Knackpick? I am Snow Able.
And as he's like, kind of like, you know, introducing himself, he's moving like this series of ropes that are over on the side and basically pulling them and securing them to hooks. And as he does, you can see these three pit traps in the main entrance all kind of like lock in place.
Ooh, yeah, make note of those ropes and which positions they happen to be in.
Yep.
Your people are very industrious.
Kind of thinks for a minute. It's like, yes. Stops big ones and animals from coming into the warrens.
Very smart.
And the rest of you basically just hear, like, chirping and growling.
Right. Yeah, I'll translate for them okay. between conversation.
Okay. Perfect.
Sorry, real quick, does this guy visually look different from the kobolds we encountered before?
I think they're a different color.
They are a different color. He's got kind of dark grayish colored scales, very similar to the dead kobold bodies you saw around the sycamore tree.
Right. Okay. Cool.
He's like, and as he kind of leads you, he leads you down and then through a tunnel off to the, off to the right, past a couple of alcoves, and you guys can see as you travel in some of the alcoves, there are other kobolds that are kind of hiding in positions. So if somebody was to breach the front and come in, there are kobolds waiting in the wings. So even though there's one guard, there are others in position should something get in.
Yeah, Hall will start making a mental count.
Yep, same.
Basically, they're very well hidden until they kind of see Nakpik leading you, and then they kind of, they kind of yell out Nakpik, what's going on? And Nakpik's like, big ones fought the gremlins. Want to talk to the chief? And then they kind of go back into the hiding spot, keeping an eye, but because you guys are being guarded. They just let you pass.
Lots of peaks.
Yeah. And basically they kind of lead you around down this way.
So if we have to fight our way out, it's definitely going to get rough.
Yep.
It'll be a slog, yeah.
Yeah, and for those of you who are kind of keeping a mental count, there's not a lot of them. There's two here, another one over there, they're kind of staggered and not a great number of them.
Mm-hmm. So a dozen maybe?
Between the entrance and down to this point here, there's four.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
First. Yeah, the feeling that they would probably, strike up from surprise, maybe yell out a warning to, warn others deeper into the complex.
Hmm.
As opposed to having a standing army, waiting for somebody to come in.
Still, 5 total on guards, not bad.
Here, yep, exactly.
And they lead you up into this area.
I'm honestly just pleased it's not cramped.
It's not. It's it looks actually it was an abandoned mine. So not only is everything made for medium-sized people, but actually a little bit bigger than that because it's a mine. And there are still the structural supports, the wooden support beams and everything are still in place.
Oh, that's nice.
Flowers, is there any ore left in there?
Do I see any ore left in here?
Why don't you give me a, let's call it a crafting roll.
Sure.
With the bonus from your stone cunning. Which is a +2 circumstance bonus.
Ooh,
it still says +1 here. Add another circumstance one. Hold on. Why is that not adding? Here, we'll just add +1 to whatever this is. I don't know. I'm still rubbing rain water out of my eyes.
Yeah, stupid rain. It's in your beard. You're
forever to dry.
You can tell that the mine has been worked fairly recently. You don't know whether the kobolds are still mining it or whether they've moved in since the last time it was worked, but the actual working of the mine and the parts that you've traveled through has been fairly recent.
Okay. can't really tell if there's much more left here, but recently worked.
Well, it's good to find out if we can.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe once my beard dries, I'll be able to focus more on what's around here.
Can't smell the ore over my wet beard.
It might be decent ears.
So this room that you get led to, there's like some beds like scattered about, like, and by beds I mean piles of loose fur kind of scattered through. There's like a couple of cooking fires. There's a large mound of furs kind of like framed up with like sticks mounted with the skulls of birds and small animals that have been kind of like painted an ashy gray color. And in here there's a slightly larger kobold, judging from his not necessarily like finer garb, but you know, more feathers on it, more, you know, animal bones on it.
Feathers makes it better.
Feathers does make it better. And your guide Knackpick is like, "Chief, big ones, who fought the gremlins. They want to talk to you." And again, you know, it's all in Draconic. But the chief says, he responds in Draconic, he's like, interesting. And then in Common, he says, "Welcome.
Ah, pleased to meet you, Chief Sutscale?
Sutscale.
I am Snow Maple, and these are my allies. The big ones who would rule over this land have given the charge to us. And we have been exploring. We found your enemies, Mifflets? Is that what they were?
Oh, yes.
Yes. We sought the release of one of your people from them, but they would not give them up. And we were forced to kill them.
Do not apologize for killing Mifflets. We have been fighting with them for many months now.
Well, we were hoping that with the blow that we have set against them, that your people would have the advantage and be more inclined to form an alliance with us.
And he kind of seems to be sizing you up. He's like, "Maybe you can do my tribe a favor."
Oh?
When the gremlins attacked last, they stole a statue of old Sharptooth. The statue is not returned soon. Sharptooth's curse will take my people, and they will wither and die.
We have that.
In that case, I have great news for you. We were able to liberate your statue from them.
You have the statue? And there's a bunch of whispering in Draconic from like the kobold warriors behind him. So it's not me, but it's like, if they have the statue, that means maybe they are strong enough to kill the usurper.
We do have the statue. In return, though, for returning it to you, I would hope that you would return some items significant to our people. There was a shiny ring that was lost.
Hmm. They seem to, again, conferring amongst themselves in Draconic. It's like, it basically is like, the chief seems to be like, if they've killed Mitflitz, then they're strong warriors. Perhaps they will be our salvation. He kind of turns to you. And for the first time, like when you first came in, he seemed like maybe he was like a little bit, not nervous, but a little bit anxious. And that seems to be replaced with a kind of a sense of confidence.
Yeah, it's good.
The treasures that we have taken from the Mitflitz, from the Gremlins. Tartuk has them.
Mm-hmm.
And when he says the name Tartuk, there's like this like bite of anger in his voice.
And Tartuk is bad.
Tartuk started this war. Said that the Mitflitz were our enemies. We could destroy them, take their lands. Believe that any who question his right are bad kobolds and sacrifice to prevent the curse from taking hold.
Right. And Tartuk is here? No.
Tartuk's quarters are to the south of us. He kind of gestures.
Oh, so it's like an infighting thing.
And yeah, people can give me an insight roll.
People who understand what's going on.
We'll translate for you. No, he was speaking common, wasn't he?
Yeah, the chief speaks in common to you guys.
Oh, right.
Insight. What is insight?
Cool. I'm making sure these kobolds don't get antsy. I rolled a one.
Actually, Pathfinder, I don't think has insight.
Yeah, I don't see it.
So it would be society.
Oh, that makes sense.
And you rolled a one, Tom?
Yep, absolutely did.
Okay.
Holy shit, I got something that
sorry,
wasn't...
mechanically, do I, like, I'm new, so do I know that this is going to, like, would this make me think that everybody's going to want to kill us and I need to protect us all? Like, what's the sort of fault?
Yeah, basically a one is a one reduces your success level by one, so if it was a failure it becomes a critical failure, that sort of thing.
So
you can definitely sense tension in the air.
Okay, gotcha. It's getting real thick sort of thing. Okay.
But for like everybody else, like given the fact that they seem to have referred to this Tartuk as a usurper, indicates that he's the one that's technically in charge, but the fact that Nakpik led you here to this chief instead of to Tartuk means that this group up here that you're with, you're guessing, is still loyal to the chief. There's definitely kind of like a little minor kind of civil war going between Chief Sootscale here and this Tartuk individual.
But everybody that we've dealt with so far is on Sootscale's side.
Everybody that is in this room with you don't know about the ones that you passed?
Well, they were all quite deferential to Nakpik.
Right. Doesn't necessarily mean they're on the same side, but Nakpik does seem to have like a little bit of status amongst them. But the folks that are here in this room with you definitely are like, you know, loyal to the chief and have concerns about this usurper.
I'm confused. Your society, the way your people work. Who's actually in charge here?
Well, that seems to be up for debate at the moment.
The chief says, no debate. Tartuk came, showed magic, claims to be a priest of Sharptooth. Frightened many of the kobolds. Those who questioned his right to rule were sacrificed to prevent the curse from taking hold.
Sacrificing your own people.
Those who would not fall sway with him. So
right.
Some paid lip service, but are still loyal to me. But perhaps those who would kill the gremlins could also kill Tartuk.
I'm picking up what you're laying down.
I'm curious about a particular point, though, Snow Maple, if I may.
Yeah, sure.
So Tartuk's in charge because he took charge.
Well, he's got magic and stuff. He's cheating.
He claims to be a priest sent by Old Sharptooth. Gift from the gods.
And in your society, the one that takes charge is in charge, or?
I mean, he's obviously not got the best interests of people in mind. Look at it. He's sacrificing them to the, you know, whatever, and getting them to go to war. It's not groovy.
We don't know that.
We don't it's not true. Know that.
True.
Tartuk is not the rightful ruler. He is taken control by his magic. He has started a war with the gremlins that has cost many kobold lives.
Yeah. He's a bad dude.
He is a kobold?
He is.
What kind of magic has he got? Like I don't know much about magic, but these guys do.
He's magic from the gods. He can make multiples of himself. He can cause a great deal of pain with but a glance. He can fire bolts of divine energy that never miss.
Oh, I've seen that one. And I'll point to Moonpine. You got that one, right?
Yeah, I've got that one.
Yeah.
That doesn't make him a priest. Makes him a wizard.
Well, I think we could probably take him, get his number punched pretty soon here.
Maybe one of them found a book somewhere.
Did Tartuk come from outside the clan?
Yes.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So he's an interloper. Well, I think we can help you out.
If you can, if I am able to rule my people again, we will work with you.
Excellent. I think it will work out great for everybody.
Come to an understanding.
Let's go find a heretic.
I think, as a show of good faith, I am going to give Suitscale the statue.
Okay.
Didn't really get a chance to mention it on the way here, but it was covered in blood or something when we found it, wasn't it?
It was, like, dirty and some dried on blood, like maybe somebody was bludgeoned to death with it.
Okay. Just going to say, Traxton, we'll probably suggest cleaning it off, maybe. But anyway.
None of us really knew anything about it. We don't know if that's how it's supposed to look or not. I don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
So yeah, when you take it, he will hold on to it for a second.
It's pretty small, right? Like I can just hand it to him.
Yeah, it's, you know, like a foot tall sort of thing, if that.
Yeah. I just didn't want to give him like this ridiculously tall statue or something.
Says, thank you.
All right, you guys hang tight. We're gonna go see if we can sort out this Tartuk guy.
This is not behavior we're used to from the big ones.
Well, you know, hopefully this will be the start of a good friendship.
Sorry, the chief did mention what the statue was of, right?
Yes, some being called Old Sharptooth.
Right. Not that I'm great at that, but is there some role to do to recognize who that being is?
It would be religion.
Okay. Do I need to be trained in it?
You do not need to be trained for recall knowledge, actually.
Awesome.
I mean, I might as well try that, too.
Okay.
I mean, it could be his grandfather for all snow maple knows.
Right, but like we never identified it yet, right? Like we just looked at it and we're like, dragon.
Yeah,
I rolled a 3, so probably not good.
Okay. You can't tell. Like maybe it's just like the kind of like crude nature of the statuary. You can't tell. And the religions that Traxton's passingly familiar with and Hull has studied, there's a wide variety of horned, but like winged things.
Mm-hmm.
So, and yeah, for all you know, it could possibly even be a, like a winged kobold, maybe.
Sure. Maybe.
Or as Asmodeus.
Remember to ask the professor about it next time I see him.
Yeah. It could be Asmodeus.
Yeah. So I was wondering what kind of flavor of statue are we handing over here. Okay.
Okay, Snow Maple, are we going to go talk to this one, or are we just going to kick his door down?
What do you think? Like, morally? Because I know that sometimes is the stickler for you.
Well, morally, I'm curious about who's supposed to be in charge here. What their laws are. If it's might makes right, then we're shortly going to be in charge. If it's
mostly at Christmas,
whoever can scare the people the most, then that's not really our jam, I don't think.
I think Chief Sootscale is the rightful ruler. But this guy came in and kind of bullied him and everybody else around.
It's a feeling I'm getting.
Either way, I think Sootscale is our best bet for someone who will be cooperative with us going forward. And if we try to keep the kobold casualties to a minimum, some of them will perhaps rejoin the fold, so to speak.
Dare I suggest that you perhaps have a conversation with this usurper? Just to get his side.
Right, all right.
And if he's belligerent, then we'll introduce him to Flower.
Do I get stopped at any point along the way?
Nope. But as you start to like approach down around the corner, you do hear voices speaking in Draconic. And it seems like one of the guards along the way has probably come down and informed folks that the big ones are here, because that seems to be the topic of a conversation.
I will call out in Draconic. Greetings! We have come to parley!
And voices step forward.
Come join us, everybody.
And yeah, and in here, this looks like there's a like a like kind of rickety wooden frame with like kind of running the perimeter. On the frame, there's like banners cut from like strips of old blanket and horse hide and stuff, covering like floor to ceiling. And they are painted with like kind of eerie icons and mystic symbols.
Right.
Religious or arcane?
This would be... This would be nature, actually.
Oof.
I'll roll for it.
A nature roll?
A nature roll.
I like the recall knowledge button. That makes it much easier.
It does.
I got a 13 on this one.
Ooh, maybe this is his spellbook.
Alright, Snow Maple, you can't make any heads or tails out of it, but...
yeah, magic stuff.
But Traxton, actually.
Oh!
As you're looking at these... Like, because that's the first thought that goes through your mind. Like, are these religious symbols? Are they arcane symbols? But they're not. These are. You've seen symbols like this before. You don't quite know exactly what they mean, but you know that somehow these are very crude, and not even accurate. Symbols tied to the Fae.
Oh. As I'm looking at him, I think I just would mutter something like, I think this guy is trying to ward against Mitflitz or something.
Yeah. That's the idea. Oh, you think he's trying to take their magic?
I don't know. Keep them out of here? Lots of fey themes running through here, and here. He would just like point to the different whatever made him think of that.
Gotcha.
But this kind of like purple-skinned kobold kind of turns and says like, what can Tartuk do for you?
We have been led to believe that you are the one responsible for the conflict between the kobold tribe here and the gremlins to the north.
The kobolds need more territory. The gremlins have territory. They are weak. The kobolds are strong.
Is he talking common or Dracon?
He's speaking common.
Okay.
I see. Your counterpart, Sootscale, seems to believe that you are a danger to your people.
Sootscale is a fool. He'd be happy to live here in the mines, never expand, never grow.
Oh, we have offered him an excellent opportunity for growth.
Why would you offer that to him?
He's been quite reasonable. But he believes that you are a problem.
Does he? He has sent you to correct this problem.
I'm just going to get a little closer to him. And I would suggest that you could perhaps correct the problem yourself if you wished.
Well, as you start stepping forward,
mm-hmm.
when you're about there, the kobold warriors kind of like draw weapons.
Okay.
Folks should probably roll initiative.
Here we go.
Because what you do may matter. They're drawing their weapons as you start to step forward, but whether they attack or not may depend.
As we're sort of standing here talking or whatever, I would like to designate
Tartuk
as my hunted prey, please.
Certainly can.
Thank you. I rolled a 5 for my initiative. On point, or on brand, I should say.
Ooh. All right.
Oh, flower.
So, Flower, you're up first. You see, like, Snow Maple starts to take a step, and the kobolds kind of, like, draw. What do these kobolds? Spears, probably. Draw their spears.
Flower is holding his... Oh, he... Getting ready with the I-beam, but he has it, like, balanced on his shoulder at the moment. Like, holding it... Like as if he had like a bat on his shoulder. He's just gonna look at Father Hall and Snow Maple and be like, guys.
Yeah.
Okay. So
mash time.
So are you going or would you like to just like delay your action?
I'm going to delay my action until hostile action is taken on either side.
Okay, basic. So you can kind of jump into the initiative at whatever point.
Sure.
That kobold. Just gonna like, just move over there, kind of moving into like a guarding position. And it's gonna use two actions to ready an action should anybody try to close with Tartuk. That one is going to do the same. Father Liam.
Liam's going to reach over and cast Magic Weapon on Flower's I-beam.
Okay.
I think I need to target him.
Yep.
And that's two actions. His third action will be to raise his shield.
Okay. Snow Maple, you've seen like two of these kobolds kind of like step into like guarding positions with their spears out.
Right. Can I make a social roll of some sort to try and convince these three kobold warriors that Tartuk is not worth dying for? And that Sootscale has offered them leniency should they abandon him.
You can try. You've talked to them long enough. Normally to like make an impression, to make a request, you need to talk to them for at least a minute. But you've had some conversation with them. So
I'll even make the appeal in Draconic if that helps.
Yeah. You can certainly try. You can target one of them. You can't target all three.
Sure. But you know, if one of them gets it, they might, you know, see the rest of them, or the rest of them might see. What would that be?
It would be, in this case, it is diplomacy.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Right. Unfortunately, 19 is not enough.
All right.
But that's largely just due to the fact that they are basically not friendly to you, so the difficulty goes up.
But I will give Flower the Nod.
Okay. Right.
Try to keep him alive, Flower. Yeah.
And you do still have two actions left.
Yeah. Can I attempt to create a diversion?
You can try to create a diversion on one.
Just like fake him out or something? I don't know. I don't know what I'll do. I'll make one of them think that I'm going to shoot at him. Like that one in the back there that's beside Tartuk.
Okay.
I'll take aim at him real quick and try and fake him out.
Okay. So we will we'll try this as create a diversion. So that is a deception roll.
There's a button for that.
Yeah, actually create diversion affects everybody whose perception DC is less than or equal to your result. How perceptive are these guys? That is exactly enough.
Ooh!
They all flinch.
So you are considered to be hidden from all of the kobolds.
Oh, really?
Yep. When you are successful, you become hidden to each creature whose perception in DC is less than or equal to your result. So you are considered to be hidden. Until the end of your turn, or until you do anything except for step or use hide or sneak.
Okay. I'm gonna step for my third action out of Flower's way.
Okay. And don't forget, you could sneak, which lets you move up to half your speed.
Oh, okay, sure.
And then by the time you're done that, if you're, like, behind cover sort of thing, you're considered to be hidden.
Can I duck in here, like, behind this bit of wall?
Yeah, those are, like, the banners that are hung up, so you can just kind of, like, duck behind one, like, one would duck behind a curtain sort of thing.
Yeah. All right, cool. Let's do that.
Perfect. So you kind of, like, fake them out and then deke over there to the, over to the right?
Yeah, give Flower the nod.
Okay. Alright, Flower, would you like to go?
Flower's gonna take his turn. Not thinking anything about the whole idea that they're kobolds, Flower is going to go right to there.
Alright, when you do, that is going to trigger the kobold warriors.
It's okay. No.
I forgot to target.
It's tricky.
So many games. Oof.
That's okay.
That'll do it.
Oh, only 8 points on a critical.
I know his pain.
But he does get an extra d4 because you're flat-footed. Which is also doubled.
Wait, Flower's flat-footed?
Yeah, because he's flanked by these two kobolds.
Oh, right. Shit. Okay, gotcha.
Oh, I already had my thing, and I forgot to hit the draw.
Yep.
Actually.
All right. So that is going to be... that is going to be some damage anyway.
That's okay.
But yeah, as you charge in, these two kobolds working in like unison basically skewer you. But now you get the remainder of your actions.
Oh, I'm going to try and flatten Tartuk.
Okay.
Flower has 55 hit points now?
Yeah, he does.
Time we level up again, you're going to have twice my hit points.
Barbarians, right?
Yeah. Oh, that is a hit.
That's a solid thwacking.
Yep. He seems surprisingly robust for a kobold.
Good, because I'm going to hit him again.
That magic weapon's so good.
Get him on the backswing.
Nice.
This is the first time I've hit twice in a turn.
I think it might be.
I mean, it's kind of rare that you have to hit twice.
Okay.
I don't know.
Alright.
A couple of fairly middling hits, but, you know, getting damage on target.
When I'm done with you, you'll be a pancake.
Alright, well, this kobold warrior, seeing that you're, like, attacking his boss, is going to try to stab you.
Does he give any thought at all to surrendering?
No.
That's next round.
It's okay.
And he's going to back up a little bit. All right, Tartuk.
I like his instincts. He's going to be the one that lives.
All right, he is going to... cast Mirror Image on himself.
Oh.
So he mutters under his breath, and these three images kind of like appear kind of circling around him. And then he is going to... Oh, he doesn't have his sickle out. He's going to draw his sickle.
Nice toothpick you have there.
That is him. That will take us to Moot Pint.
Moot Pint's going to cast Shield Cantrip on himself. And... I don't know how powerful Tartuk is, so I will use that Hideous Laughter spell on him. That's a DC 18 save, I think.
Yep, from where you are, though, you cannot see Tartuk.
Well, I guess I'll just move there.
Okay.
Let's shields on. Do I still have enough room to use the Hideous Laughter?
No, because it's an action for shield, an action to move, and then two actions for Hideous Laughter.
Right. Shoot him with your crossbow or something.
Yeah, why not?
Might take one of his shields down, or one of his images, rather.
Alright, so it takes your action to draw out your crossbow.
Ah.
Alright.
Okay. But you're into position, shields up. See these like things. Tartuk is definitely an arcane caster, you would know that. That will take us to Traxton.
Alright. I'm not gonna be able to get to my preferred prey this turn without shenanigans. So I'm gonna move to here. Get some support. Okay. And make a single attack.
Okay.
Probably not great. I rolled a 6.
Oh, I forgot to have my thing on. So it'd be a 15 total.
I'm still hidden, right, Chris?
You are hidden.
Cool.
15 is a miss against a kobold.
Okay.
All right. Kobold warrior number one. And the kobolds are basically just taking pokes at Flower since he's right there.
Poor Flower.
The 19 hit?
19 hits, because you're clumsy because of the weapon.
Oh, right, yeah. That's right.
Alright, so they are basically trying to stab. And actually, this kobold here... demoralize Flower. He doesn't speak Draconic, so there's a -4, but he's going to give it a try. Oh, failed to demoralize Flower. Oh, well. So he chitters something at you in a language you don't understand, Flower.
I don't speak lizard.
Alright, Father Liam.
Poor Flower. He's our tank, I guess, so. I'm gonna stride.
Okay.
There, I guess. That's as far as I can go. 5, 15, 20.
Ooh, combat music. Just kicked in now.
I realized, like, I have music. Why isn't it playing?
I'm gonna drop 2 action heal on Flower. Got him targeted. Awesome. Cast 2 living. Healing. There you go, big guy.
Ooh.
Lovely.
That's the juice.
Yeah, the
all the wounds just stitch up.
The scaling for heal is really nice, like that +8 per level.
Huge.
So. Alright.
They thought they had him trapped, but they do not.
I'm not trapped in here with them. They're trapped in here with
me. Okay.
Uh-huh.
That will take us to Snow Maple. You're hidden from the kobolds, but not from Tartuk.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Well, it will make me easier. It will make it easier to get to the back of him.
Okay.
And then we will rapier and short sword him from behind. Flat footed for flanking?
Yeah, it's already counted in.
Alright, cool.
Not bad.
You destroy one of his images. That hits.
Oh, the 2 gets through? Oh.
Yeah. Well, it hits him. I don't know if it hits his mirror image or not. So on a 1 or a 2 on a d6. Oh, does hit him.
Dang, I was hoping to get rid of another image for Flower's next big swing.
Yep. Alright, but you do stab him. That was 2 with your sneak attack damage.
Yeah.
Oh, double
2
ones.
Dice.
Oh,
2 dice, ones. 2 damage. Woohoo.
Oh. Alright, Flower, you're up.
I'm just gonna keep trying to crush Tartuk. I know it's gonna be a little harder, but yeah, we'll do what we can do.
Okay. Ooh, 22 hits.
Rock.
Hits one of his images.
Still roll the damage, or?
Nope.
Swinging again.
But now I think there's only like two Tartuks or three?
There are two Tartuks.
There are two Tartuks.
I'm going to hero point.
Okay.
Reroll using a
hero. Okay.
Oh. Okay.
Almost.
It's okay. And I can swing again.
You can.
With a plus zero.
This is the one that crits. No.
Ah.
Oh, 17's a miss. Wow.
Yeah.
It's okay.
17's a miss and he's flanked. All right. The Kobold Warrior. Somebody just cast healing magic.
Hi.
So he will take out his, actually he's got his spear out, so he'll just throw a spear at you. Nope. And then he will... He will try to demoralize Fog. Oh, you're out of range of his demoralized, so you can't do that. Well, he'll draw a sling and fire off a sling then.
I mean, targeting the healer makes sense.
Yep, that will miss. That will take us to Tartuk. This barbarian looks like he might be a threat.
Oh, he is.
Yeah. So he will draw out. No, he won't draw out. Alright, so I'm going to need a will save from Flower.
Okie dokie.
Probably not his best save.
It's his second best save. He's an expert in them. Save.
Oh,
I'm going to re-roll that with a hero point.
I was
going to
say, critical failure in a save.
I have something for that. Fun.
How many hero points? Oh, we got lots of hero points.
I don't think I have anything else besides that. Okay, I'll just re-roll the hero point.
Okay. So that is a success. So you don't take the persistent. So you just take the initial damage. So only 7 psychic damage.
That's my least favorite type of damage. It hurts my brain.
And there's only so much brain there to work with.
Oh, wow. What's happening here?
He cast persistent pain on Flower, but Flower made the save.
Little do you know, my life is constant pain.
And he's going to move over there so he doesn't get stabbed in the back.
Oh, but I like him getting stabbed in the back.
That will take us to Moot Point.
Somebody take out this kobold in front of me, between us.
And I can't see, right, Tartuk?
Correct, he just ducked around the side.
He's determined to make you waste an action to move.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the action economy is for.
So I'll move there.
Okay.
And I will not... And I will cast shield, and I will fire the crossbow. At Tartuk.
15 is a miss.
That's fine.
That will take us to Trexton.
Sure. I'm going to reassign my hunted prey to the kobold right next to me.
Okay.
I'm going to get some support from my friend, and I will do a twin takedown, please.
Okay.
I might as well give up. That's a 3 for the first attack. Second one might do something. 14 for the second.
The second one hits.
Perfect. 2d8. So 8 damage on dice.
Is that including Grax?
Yeah, his. So I rolled 2d8. Like a d8 from. Okay. This is my second attack, so this is the short sword, right?
Yep.
Right, so it's a d6 and a d8. Apologies.
No worries.
Same number, 8.
Okay.
I think I have like a +4 bonus to damage or something.
You have a... +3.
Okay. With the... All right, it's the short sword. Correct.
All right. He is still standing. All right.
He's badly injured.
He is. But still got a barbarian flank, so may as well stab the barbarian. Take advantage of the flank while he can.
Well, he still draws breath.
Okay. He's gonna back up to there. Protect his boss. This kobold no longer has a barbarian flanked.
Yeah, your buddy just left you for dead, pal.
And he just got attacked from behind. I'm gonna turn around and deal with Traxton.
That bear is gonna eat you.
Oh, morale's getting real low.
Oh.
He shook.
Over to there. That will take us to Father Liam.
Okay, these guys don't have opportunity attacks or haven't used them yet.
Yeah, they don't seem to be trained warriors.
Despite their sobriquet.
He's gonna move here, obviously up around the corner. That's a stride. Okay. I'm going to raise my shield.
Okay.
And I'm going to attempt to grapple Tartuk.
All right.
Well, that grapples.
Which is what? Athletics, I think, right?
Yep. Or from your action tab, just choose grapple.
I don't see it on the action tab.
The one, like the total action is the one that gives all of them.
Oh, that one. Grapple.
Should be bottom of the second column.
Yeah.
Yep, grab that guy.
Ooh, critical failure.
I'll spend a hero point.
Okay.
Ooh, there's a lot of keywords there.
Yeah. Grabbed.
Okay. 16 is enough to grapple him.
This guy's pretending he's a priest, but he's a mage, so Hall is gonna shake the shit out of him.
What?
He's not happy. Or at least that's what Hall thinks.
Against target's fortitude DC. 16 is a miss, actually.
Okay.
I'm
still in position. Could shield it. It's good.
Yep. All right. That will take us to Snow Maple.
Right. I'll move down to flank this guy.
Okay.
And I will whisper in his ear in Draconic that he should have surrendered.
But he did.
All right.
Oh.
He probably should have surrendered.
Yeah. And then for a bonus action, can I try to demoralize the other guy? After just like stabbing his bro through the head?
You sure can.
I'm not the best at it, but we'll see. Oh, I am. I'm at least as good as Professor, maybe.
The big advantage is you actually speak the language.
Oh, cool.
Because there's a -4 if they can't understand you.
Oh, he's frightened.
So yes, he is frightened. That will take us to Flower.
Oh, Tartuk.
All right. Flower isn't even going to charge. He's just going to walk up.
How do we fix that persistent damage?
Thought I got rid of the persistent damage, didn't I?
Yeah, you shouldn't have taken it.
Okay. I'm gonna swing on him.
Oh, so the persistence damage is not on.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
That hits his last mirror image.
Ah. Gonna swing on him again. Have him in a corner.
It's okay, buddy. He's got nowhere to run now.
We could arrest him.
PvP zone just by saying. Yourself.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I didn't bring any shackles.
This guy up here, he's got a sling out. He may as well like throw a sling stone at Snow Maple since he can see her. Reload and fire again.
He's too scared.
Tartuk.
Hello, heretic.
Check something.
Wonder how many things we've killed just to get a wedding ring. Seems excessive.
It'd be a few.
Trying to figure out why.
It's sentimental value.
For some reason, one of his spells wasn't showing up. So, Flower is the big problem.
Is he?
It's one way of putting it.
So he's going to just basically reach out telekinetically, grab a piece of double thing, and make a spell attack roll.
Ooh.
So yeah, basically the dead kobold that Snowmaple just killed, Tartuk just kind of reaches down, you see it start to like shake and vibrate, and then it launches into Flower.
You just hit me with a dead thing?
You did, yep.
We're gonna get it now.
How he catapulted you.
Did, yeah.
And then he will cast shield on himself. That will take us to Moot Pint.
Moot Pint's gonna cast shield on himself and finally use that hideous laughter.
Alright, so if you target him and then select the spell, it should pull up for you.
Alright, there it is. Wow, he succeeded.
So he cannot use any reactions. Which does mean that he can't shield block. And you still have one action.
Well, shield, that took two actions, and all
right.
Shield took one.
Right, you did the shield. Right. Traxton.
I shall. The one that I hunted prey, Snow Maple ended, right?
Correct.
Sorry, buddy.
Nope, no worries. It happens all the time.
That other one's demoralized, though.
Beautiful. I'll take it. Because I can't do anything else, really, if I want to attack. So yeah, move, support, and one attack.
Okay.
Oh, I rolled 3 again. Yep.
Three, even with the frightened, is not enough.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, this Tobald. Oh, he's like surrounded. He's like, what the hell?
Surrender. It's your only chance.
He's gonna stab a ranger. He is still frightened though, so he's a little bit shaky. Ooh. He can't go anywhere, so he may as well stab 3 times.
Going for broke.
A full array of misses.
But he, at the end of his turn, he is no longer frightened. All right, Father Liam.
I mean, arguably, he should be frightened too. Should be more frightened, not less.
Well, his back's up against the wall now, so that instinct kicks in.
Hmm.
Just like lashing out blindly with his spear. Like, back, back, back.
Fight or flight. You have chosen poorly.
Alright, so Father Liam is up.
Tony might be AFK.
Alright.
Yep.
Sadly, whether or not, like, if he grabs the guy out, it'll matter for Snow Maple, so...
Oh, there he is.
Perfect. Father Liam, you're up.
Grab that tiny heretic.
Heretic, okay. I'm gonna grab him.
Okay. A 20 is enough to grab him.
Ooh, oh, heretic. He's injured, but not quite done, right?
Yeah, like, he's not even bloodied.
Yeah, it's badly injured. It started to get interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, everybody else is pretty good, right? Yeah, for help, not too bad. I'll cast Electric Arc on the two kobolds. I think I did that right. It's a DC 18 reflex.
Right. Did you just get the one kobold?
It should be both of them. I thought I had the other guy targeted.
So it's Tartuk as well.
I didn't have a
full target is left shift and T.
Yeah, I think I got him. So half damage, 8-1, 4 to the other. I mean, 12 damage is bad.
All right. That will take us to Snow Maple.
Okay, I will step into the gap and take advantage of the flat-footedness of Tartuk.
Okay.
Let me keep him alive. No, okay.
Yeah. All right. If the father wishes it, I will attempt to not fatally wound Tartuk.
All right. So it's a -2 to do non-lethal damage.
-2, eh?
Last time I grabbed somebody, Flower pasted him against my shield. So.
Yeah. I'll take the -2 on the short sword.
Alright, that is a hit.
He's still just injured, alright.
He is quite robust for a kobold.
Yeah, I'll give him one more at full strength.
Okay.
Oh, now he's too badly injured.
Right, so
that's me done.
Okay. That will take us to Flower.
All right. Flower, since Father Liam wanted non-lethal, we'll swing on him non-lethal.
Everyone's so dejected when he's saying
I mean,
that.
It is fair to operate on that knowledge, Chris. Like, we can tell that they're badly injured or whatnot.
Yep, that's why it's there.
All right.
22. Because if it's -2, then...
Yep, that is a hit.
The saddest hit ever.
Asleep.
60. Yeah, go to sleep.
Remarkably still standing.
Death again. Jason.
20. So -2. That is a miss, actually, because of his shield.
So his shield went away.
Shield went away, goes away on his turn.
Oh, okay.
I don't know why it went away, but it goes away on his turn.
Oh, okay. I just noticed the message that his shield went away. I was like, oh.
Yeah. Okay. So that is a miss.
Do it again.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, he can surrender or not.
He can surrender. Actually, we're gonna do it with a backswing because I missed.
Yep.
No.
Okay. This kobold warrior. Kobold warrior. He's gonna grab his spear. Ooh, he does not tumble through Gratch's space. He's gonna try to come up and flank Snow Maple. So instead he's gonna...
He's really drank the Kool-Aid.
He has.
I thought we were pals. Curse your sudden but inevitable betrayal.
What are you gonna do, Tartu? Tartuk is grappled, so anything he does that has manipulate, he has to make a flat check.
Where'd the other guy move to, Chris?
He didn't. He tried to tumble through Gratch so he can come up and spear you in the back.
Oh.
But he failed.
But Gratch said no.
So that doesn't move him at all?
Correct. Like, oh, okay. Basically tumble through is, you can treat the enemy space like it's difficult terrain, but if you fail, then you can't move through an enemy space.
Right. And then nowhere else for him to go, so...
Yeah, he's got no place else to go. Alright, so verbally, Tartuk is going to cast True Strike.
This is not going to work out for you.
And then he's going to telekinetically projectile Father Liam. He does have to make a DC 5 flat check. He'll take the critical hit.
Oof.
Oh, the Gratch was targeted, but that should target the guy who's grappling him.
It might not. It might not be a crit on the father, though.
That's true, because he only rolled a 27. What's your AC?
20.
Okay, so it is not a critical hit. It's just regular old damage.
Ouch.
Actually, he can roll the d20 twice and take the best. Yeah. So again, spear comes zinging into you, whacks into you.
Well, I think we've done everything we could to have this guy surrender, so Moot Point.
All right, Moot Point is up.
All right. You're okay with the crossbow bolt then?
Or a giant magic missile if the shield's down?
Oh, the shield's down? Then, yeah let's hit him with, what level am I now? Do I get three magic missiles, right?
It's one per action.
One per action, so three magic missiles.
Yep. So, 3d4 plus 3.
Yep, just make sure I'm targeting him.
I mean, we tried.
You got it now.
Well, that's not very much.
I'm still standing. That will take us to Traxton.
All right. Hunt prey, support, and twin takedown.
Perfect. Yeah, this little kobold here tried to stab Gratch a bunch of times.
Yeah, I don't like that. Neither does he. First roll is a 16. Second roll is a 14.
Both hits.
Beautiful. All right. 2d8, 3d8, and a d6. Dice-wise, that is 9, 17 damage thus far. Plus a bunch more.
He's already dead.
So yeah, so as he's like stabbing furiously at Gratch, you know, you kind of like look at him, kind of like size up his weak spots, kind of nod to Gratch, and the two of you fall on this poor little kobold and like destroy him.
Excellent.
That will take us to Father Liam.
Father Liam has had about enough of this guy. I'm going to try to slam him to the ground, to trip.
Okay.
Huh. Oh no.
That is not a trip.
That is not.
It's a trip for somebody.
So you try to trip him, and at the last minute, he kind of puts his like legs against the wall and kind of ends up tripping you instead. You fall prone.
Son of a... I'm going to stand up.
Okay.
Second action, third action. I'm going to just punch this thing in the head.
Okay.
Spike gauntlet. Not non-lethal.
Did you get the minus two?
No, I didn't. Sorry.
Okay. So minus two, that is a miss.
Okay.
And at the end of your turn, he is no longer grabbed.
Hall is getting very frustrated.
Snow Maple.
Yeah, all right. I'll do twin feint.
Okay. And then he is flat-footed against your second attack.
Yeah, so is that plus two, minus two?
Just put in your minus two. I've marked them as flat-footed.
Gotcha. Ooh, what a rodent. I'm gonna spend a hero point on that one.
All right. There
we
go.
There we go.
24 is a hit.
There we go. All right. Him with the backswing.
Perfect. So you faint and you... You stab in deep with the second weapon, and as you pull it out, instead of a spurt of blood, there's like vines that kind of come out with your dagger.
Oh, I did take the minus two to not kill him.
Yep, and as you do, the vines basically start to like expand out from the wound. And essentially envelop him in just like leaves and vines until the point where you cannot see his body anymore. But you do see a trickle of blood
I didn't do that.
Whoa.
We just saw you do this.
No, I didn't. I was trying to like stab him in the shoulder. Just wing him a little bit.
And as the blood kind of pools at the feet, the vines start to wither, and you see like just a dead, desiccated kobold. Like every bodily fluid has been squeezed out of him.
I'd say you winged him.
Okay.
A bit excessive.
I mean, I don't think this short sword has that power. To be fair, I don't think I got it identified. I don't know.
And Mootpint, in your head, you hear, well, that was a disappointment.
Really? Okay. What did you want?
I had hopes. We'll see.
Could you be more vague? And I'm talking out loud so these guys can hear me. He's long since lost the shame that it comes with talking to himself.
And there it goes again. Now, Snow Mabel, can you take a look at Flower?
Yeah, sure.
The remains, the plant material is completely dead now?
It is very rapidly dying. And Traxton actually can give me a nature roll.
Yes, please. I was going to ask if I could. That's might be not bad. 16.
Oh, that was supposed to be on. Supposed to be on Flower. Seven
yep.
points.
Yep, got it. All right, so Traxton, these flowers, as you're looking at them, these are none of these plants are natural. You've never seen any of these plants before. The texture of the leaves, the like vibrancy of the stalks before they shrivel, the vibrancy of the color of the flower petals. These flowers are it is nothing that you've encountered in the natural world.
Okay.
I'll spend one on that.
Does it look like all those factors have been cranked up to like 9,000, or is it like
26 on Father Hall?
Nice.
He can't take nearly that many hit points. Feels so good.
But yeah, Traxton, these it looks like something has, like it's not even that these are normal flowers that have been amplified. These are flowers you have never seen.
Okay. Just completely foreign to my experience.
Completely foreign to your experience. And even like your little leshy familiar, it's kind of whistling under his breath like, woof, I don't know. I have no idea what that is.
Okay.
But almost as quickly as they erupt from Tartuk, once they have basically erupted and squeezed the life out of him, they almost immediately start to wither and die.
Okay. And it is like a ringing of a sponge. They're not like feeding on him or anything, are they?
Yeah, no, they basically just like squeeze the life juice out of him, most of which is in a puddle where he was standing.
Right, okay. Constrictor vines-ish.
I'm going to go check on the third kobold warrior.
Okay. There is just a puddle of goop and a bunch of dying plants.
Oh shit! And it wasn't just him. It was the other guy too.
Anyone know what's going on?
Can I make a roll like Arcana or something? Or library lore?
Maybe
lore master.
You could try a nature roll.
Sure.
I think they made a deal with somebody. It's my guess based on those symbols and what's happening here.
The tab came due.
Yeah.
So what we got going on there?
They failed.
The same sort of thing. Like the plants, like as far as you and Snow Maple are like, you're like, that's peculiar.
Yeah.
Never heard of anything like this happening before. Never seen anything like this happen before.
You said the plants were not familiar, Chris. Do any of them look useful?
By the time you get to check on them, they are like long dead.
All right.
Yeah, I probably couldn't tell anyway.
I was just wondering if we might recover some useful seeds or something.
Oh, okay. I gotcha. I thought you meant like, do we know what we could use it for?
Yeah. No, and like I said, like they literally spring up, kill the thing, and then like dry out.
Right.
All right. Well, see if any of the loot survived.
Right. Poke around on the boss's body once it's been squeezed out.
All right. So you do find some stuff kind of tucked away. And the boss has a wand on him.
Oh.
So there's a couple of decent looking arrows. There is a runestone. There's a strange dust. There is what appears to be a wedding band.
Nice.
A small handful of gold.
And you said there was a wand of some sort?
Right.
Yep, just give me one sec. And on Tartuk's body, there is a wand.
Right.
So there is a couple of arrows, a stone with a rune carved into it, a packet of dust, and a wand.
Okay.
Out of curiosity, is there an overly plant motif to this wand?
No, there is not.
Okay.
Let's get it in the bag. We can look at it later.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. I dumped it into the cavern loot there.
Gotcha. So we've got unusual object, two unusual ammunition. Oh, a third unusual object. And wedding ring. And a sack.
And a sack. Oh, sweet. And also in the sack, moot point, there is a hand mirror, a wooden frame, made out of, silvered glass, with around the handle, there's a winding vine with little flowers on it.
Oh, I'll ping that with the detect magic.
There is magic in the area.
All right. Well, clearly. All right. Well, I'll look in the mirror and see if there's anything interesting. If it does anything.
Give me a... Let's call this a willpower save.
No.
Save.
Yeah, good luck with that. I'm going to go let Chief Sitscale know that we're all good to go here.
Yep. Usurper has been neutralized.
Well, that one has.
Right. So yeah, it's a very nice mirror there, Moot Point. The sort of thing that you should probably hang on to and keep with you forever.
Lovely. Lovely.
Definitely don't let anybody else touch it.
My precious.
Squeeze it, hug it, and call it George.
Yeah, and I'll put that in my backpack.
Okay. Alright, so when you get back to Chief, the Chief, he's talking to his warriors. He says,
Tartuk is taken care of. Unfortunately, we were not able to sway any of his disciples from his cause.
I'm not surprised some of them are fanatical in their devotion.
We are concerned that perhaps they were under some sort of curse. As vines and things came to claim them upon his death.
That is something that we will keep an eye open for. But the Sootskill Kobolds, thank you for your assistance. And we would consider ourselves to be on good terms.
Excellent. I will inform them that should they require our aid in the future, they should send a runner to Oleg's place.
We do not know where that is.
I'll give them directions.
Thank you. And he kind of like holds out like a scaly draconic hand to kind of like shake hands.
Sure.
And the rest of like the warriors that are with him kind of like line themselves up in like some semblance of order. And then kind of like clasp their spears to their chest and kind of like nod their heads towards you guys.
Give them, a brief nod.
And the chief will, again, he'll speak to you, say, if Tartuk was not stopped, many more would have died in our war with the gremlins. Between your actions there and here, my people owe you a great debt.
Well, we did clear them out of the tree. They might go back there at some point, so keep an eye on it. But we did send them packing for now.
But perhaps without Tartuk poisoning the well, we can discuss things with them.
Oh, yeah. That's good, too.
And you should. Big people are coming to these lands.
But you have the opportunity to get in on the ground floor.
Yes, they should learn how to coexist.
Yeah, it's not a short joke. I'm, being serious.
Well, if the good people are, or the big people are like you are, then we'll see, I suppose. But we will approach it with an open mind.
Excellent. That's all we ask.
Chief, you're mine here.
Yes.
What are you mining?
There is some iron here. Was useful against the Mitflits.
Are the veins good, or have you mined it out?
They're not rich by any stretch.
It is good that you have enough to sustain your people.
Well,
your people are good miners.
Are they?
All people are good miners if you put them in a mine and tell them where to dig.
Flowers people are excellent miners, but...
Well, we are certainly not dwarves.
We heard that there's a ore vein close. Thought maybe you'd be interested.
Perhaps. Let us have some time to regroup after our
Yeah, perhaps in time they might seek an area to expand to.
Perhaps. We've lost many in the war, but when the time is right, we will certainly be willing to discuss. My people will need work.
I'm sure we can come to some sort of arrangement.
Absolutely.
But you know how to get in touch with us, should you need us. And hopefully when we return, we'll find you here, regaining your strength, growing more populous in numbers.
We hope. We have much to do.
Our intent is to bring bounty to this land for all.
Well, thank you. Many would not have bothered even discussing things with us. They would have taken what they wanted by force. That is generally what the big people do.
We're built different.
We're a little different.
Yeah.
Well, your assistance to my people will not go unnoticed, and we will make sure that other tribes hear. So should you encounter other kobolds, let them know that Chief Sutscale has told them that they should at least speak with you.
Awesome. We are a friend of the Sutscale.
Let's say ally. Friend is a bit strong yet.
Okay. Well, you know, we'll get there someday.
We're working on it.
But you're welcome to stay here if you need to. If you need to be on your way, we can escort you back to the entrance.
How much daylight have we burned so far today?
You got here around noon, so it's probably like early afternoon.
Oh, we could make tracks if we want to, probably.
Well, we do need to do some traveling, don't we? We want to go back to Oleg's and hit the
we got to hit the
radishes anyway on
radish patch, yeah.
Yeah.
Chief.
Yes.
There's a big one not far from here that is a problem. Yeah.
So you got all robotic there.
The Staglord.
Right, I've heard of him.
Well, his presence is something that we cannot abide. Since we've helped you,
perhaps you can help us. We are currently marshaling our strength against the Staglord.
I will not send my people into a slaughter.
Oh, don't worry. We would not ask that of you.
What can we do to help that does not result in the death of my people?
Well, we got a little bit more to find out about that. But again, if you find out anything about the Staglord in the meantime, perhaps send word to Oleg's.
The Staglord has killed many in his rise to power. Entire clans of kobolds have been eliminated. Anyone who stands up to him, whether big or little people.
No, we're not telling you to get your people killed at all. But if you happen to find out anything about him, like whether his people like pass by or, you know, you capture one of them or something like that, you know, should you come into any information about the Staglord, just let us know.
That we can do.
And while you're doing that, if you run into his people, let them know there's a Justicar in the realm and his days are numbered.
Do we really want to let him know?
I'm back here?
Yes.
Okay.
We've already released some anyway, so I don't think it matters at this point.
We will pass along the message if we encounter any. I believe some of his people had a camp up on the river.
Yeah, they don't anymore.
Oh, okay. If we hear of any more camps, we will let you know.
Oh, thank you. That would be appreciative. We have, like I said, we're still exploring. We haven't had a chance to sort out everything in the local area yet.
Understandable.
But that said, I think if everyone's cool to move, we can get a little more exploring done today.
Do we want to see what, did they have anything about the immediate area to point out to us?
Sure. Yeah, that'd be helpful. If there's anything interesting nearby that they could add to our knowledge of the area, that'd be great.
We're close to the Staglord's camp. We should put eyes before we head back.
Fairly, yeah.
They probably have a lay of the land around their place anyway.
From here, what can they tell you? Mostly they can tell you about the gremlins. They can tell you that if you want an example of what the Staglord is capable of, you should check old Davik's place.
Where's that?
It's still by the bridge.
Yeah, that's the bridge that Snow Maple saw.
Oh, gotcha.
Right.
What happened? What happened there?
Davik refused to bow to the Stag Lord. They say his spirit still haunts the area.
Oh. Like a spooky, spooky haunt, or?
I do not know. I don't go there.
Fair enough.
Something has to happen for the story to exist.
What did he say it was? Davik's haunt?
Davik's Crossing.
Davik's Crossing.
But yeah, if you guys want to just get on your way, they will escort you out. They will make sure, like, as they go by, neckpick your apparently your tour guide.
Yeah.
As you make your way back out, he motions to like the different guards, the different sentries that you've seen.
Hmm.
He's like, if you see these ones, they are friends of our tribe. Yeah. Kind of passing the word along to people so that, you know, if he's not on guard or whatever, the guards will know should you guys come back this way again.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Do we see any more piles of vines on the way out? Dead vines?
No.
Okay. Cool. So they're all good.
Good question, though.
Yeah, no. Good looking out.
Yeah.
Yeah. And no more signs of those.
Okay. Before we leave Nakpik, though, I will get down on one knee and offer him a little handshake.
Okay. He'll give you a good, like, firm for a kobold handshake.
Yeah. Thanks. Thanks, Nakpik. You've been very helpful to us.
Thank you. I was going to kill you when you first arrived, but something told me that perhaps I should not. I'm glad I didn't. And
you're a wise little guy.
Like, he seems like absolute sincerity that he was going to kill all of you by himself.
Yeah, this is all in Draconic too, by the way, right?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay, cool. I was going to say, I'd just be smiling at him, but I don't know what he's saying.
And then he kind of gives you a little salute.
For the sake of good relations, I won't translate that last part for for everybody.
Yeah. It'd just be funny for Traxton, but
yeah. I mean, Flower might take it personal.
Yeah, challenge accept.
Yeah. See if we can avoid that.
All right. But yes, as you get out, like, it's still raining, but you can start to see the sun peeking through.
Good.
You've got enough time that you could probably travel a little bit if you wanted to before you had to start setting up camp. Or you can kind of explore the area that you're in.
What are we thinking? Are we feeling explorey, or do we want to vamoose?
Well, if we've just got one action, maybe we explore and then camp and then leave in the morning. But I say we head, like, when we're leaving, we go to Davik's Crossing, go
head
to the Orb.
Head up that way?
Yeah, yeah. Then throw to the Ore Vein, and then Radish Patch, and then back home.
I really, really want to get a look at that Staglord's base.
Oh. I know, pal. I don't think we're ready to tangle with it yet, though.
I know, but we get to know what we're looking at, right?
Yeah.
It's true.
Like with the spyglass from the crossing, maybe?
I just hate to have to jump the gun, but no. Yeah, we could head back that way.
I'm not married to the idea. I just... We're right there, right?
Anybody else have a thought on it?
My thought is going down that way sort of cuts down on a less efficient route of hitting a number of locations we have no idea about yet.
Yeah.
It's a little longer to get home, but gives us some intel on the Staglord, is what I'm thinking.
Oh, yeah, significantly longer to get home, I imagine. But anyway, that's my thought.
They're both valid points. My only concern is I don't necessarily want to tip our hand against the Staglord just yet.
Right.
I think there's actually very little cause to think that any of the bandits that we set free are going to report back to the Staglord.
Yeah, maybe not directly. Word will probably get out.
Maybe. But I think we've probably got a week or two at least before that happens.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Eventually it'll definitely happen. But
yeah, checking out the rest of this hex for tonight seems like a good idea.
Yeah. That's all we got time left for. Might as well.
Okay. All right, so somebody can give me a survival roll.
Okay. Got a hero point. Oh, okay. Do I have to take the roll when I re-roll when a hero point?
You do.
God, this is going real good.
Man.
I rolled a 5, and then I got a 2, so I guess I get the 2.
All right. Ouch, buddy.
Yeah. At least I hit twice before.
Well, you can't get them all, right?
Probably going to be my success for this session.
All right. So, you guys spend some time kind of like looking around this area. Doesn't seem like there's a lot here. The kobolds have basically... In the area kind of around the mine, you know, I mean, they've hunted it for food and stuff like that, so it's largely used. Given time,
keep an eye out with the spyglass.
Sure, you can definitely do that. You can give me a perception roll.
Oh, 15 might be enough.
Due to the rain, you cannot see anything.
Oh, the rain penalty. Gotcha. No worries.
As evening falls, the rain lets up. And somebody can start hunting around for a campsite.
Okay, I'll give that one a go.
Right. 16 is enough to find a campsite.
Better than the last one.
Better than the last one. So for it, does anybody want to camouflage it?
I think tonight I'm actually going to try to do some gathering because our basic ingredients are getting low.
All right. Does anybody want to cook, or are you just going to survive off of rations tonight?
I'm fine with rations.
Yeah, me too.
I mean, I want to cook, but I want to talk to Traxton. So I'm not sure if that's exclusive or not.
No, not necessarily.
So I'll cook if we have stuff.
Okay. Does anybody want to hunt or gather?
Yes, please.
Okay. Traxton, you still trying to learn haggis?
Oh, I think he's briefly away.
Okay. All right. What would Moot Pint and Flower like to do?
I could try to do the watches again, I guess.
Okay.
I don't really have any plan.
That was perception, yeah?
Yes. Alright, 18 is enough to succeed. Everybody will get a bonus on perception checks for their watch.
Nice.
Snowmaple can give me a survival roll.
Is it subsist?
No, it is not. It's a separate thing.
Oh. I always like to check the action thing first.
Oh yeah, for sure. I love the action tab for like all the little things.
Oh, I'm bad.
Failure, but you do find a number of basic ingredients equal to the zone's DC, so that is 16. 16 basic ingredients.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Cool. That's what I was going for anyway.
So. Yep. You don't find any special things. You don't find like any spider legs or anything like that, but you do find berries and roots and all that stuff.
Yeah, Snowmaple comes up back with like odd stuff too, like bugs and roots that you guys wouldn't consider food.
Ferns.
Who wouldn't consider food?
You know, city folk.
There you go.
Right. Traxton, still trying to learn haggis?
Sure.
All right, so it's a perception check.
Right. Real quick, though, are we in a bad camp? Am I on a
negative? Nope, no penalties.
Okay.
We got a regular little camp tonight.
Cool. Just wanted to be sure if I was banging my head against a wall. I rolled a 19 this time.
Oh, ooh. Nice.
That's going to be some good haggis.
Fingers crossed. Well, I'm only learning it, so.
Secure.
Yep.
Figure out why. For some reason, every once in a while, my mic goes staticky.
Tried turning it off and turning it back on again?
Just did, actually.
Oh, okay.
That worked.
There we go.
Somehow.
Yep. I don't know why, just every once in a while, it's like, no, I'm going to be all staticky now. All right, so over the course of the, you know, while Snow Maple is out hunting and everything, and Flower's kind of organizing you guys, you do learn how to make haggis from the professor.
Beautiful.
And then Father Hull wanted to have like a little scene with Traxton, so we'll do that while you guys are prepping things and before you go to bed.
Hey, Traxton, do you have a moment?
Sure.
You're a druid, yes?
Slow nod with direct eye contact.
And he's watching your eyes too. Like he's not being aggressive by any means, but he's like trying to understand.
Yeah. He's just a little just wondering where this is going, giving me a second to keep talking, that's all.
You and I, we're opposite sides of coins, I think. You were a man of the wild, primal. I'm a city folk.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be building a kingdom here. A place for many people.
Right.
The way you view the world and the way that I view the world, I believe, are significantly different, yes.
In the nuance, perhaps. I don't think in the overall picture. You want a place where people will be free and safe?
Yes.
That's what I want. Place where they'd respect nature. But not venerate it. They don't have to worship it.
We all worship different things, of course.
Agreed.
Go ahead.
No, as it should be, I'm a little interested to see where these laws you keep mentioning materialize, and when they materialize. But for now, I think we're both on the same path, just maybe different roads, so to speak.
And he'll give like a slight little smile, probably sitting cross-legged, you know, talking to Traxton. Traxton is probably standing.
Yeah, with a piece of
paper. I have a book. It's a holy book from Abadar, who shows us how to build a civilization. How to build a community. It speaks of various different ways to make a government, to hold parliament, to I would like you to read this. And I'm very interested in your insight. Your religion and mine are not the same. But that doesn't mean they're not compatible.
True. And he'll take the book. The only languages he has is common. Can he read this?
Oh, yeah. It's common.
Okay. He'll just take it and open it and look at it. Literally to be sure that he can read it and just close it. And then he'll look at it and say, this is probably a good start. And he'll look at the book and he'll look at you. But I think, and he'll get a little bit closer. And I think the best laws are going to come from here. And he points at your head. Like he reaches out and like just touches you on the side of the head. And he goes here and he comes back to himself and he touches himself on the chest.
Your heart, my mind.
Combination of both. Maybe a little bit of each from both of us, from all of us, and then like back to wherever everybody else is. He says, but I will read this, and he holds the book up to you.
Thank you. I would like to see us progress in a way that does not harm either one of our particular face. I think the insight that you have, the wisdom that you and yours have, holds a great deal of merit. Great deal of merit.
The trick is going to be able to be seen from other people's point of views. I think we can manage it.
I hope so. And if you would like to teach me, I will learn. I will try.
The most anybody could ask.
And that's the scene, I think.
Yeah.
All right.
Moot Pint, do you want to check out our collection of unusual objects?
I would. So let's do that.
Can we do that during campaign time, Chris?
You can. You can do that during downtime, since Moot Pint wasn't really doing much else.
No, he was probably playing with his mirror.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. It's a very pretty mirror, very lovely. The way the light hits it, sometimes it looks like water on the surface as opposed to like metal.
Ooh, it matches my staff. So, is there anything I can do to trigger this thing?
Not that you're aware of.
And I don't have anything I can use to identify it or the other.
So to identify magic, first, once you've figured, okay, this might be magical, then you do use the read aura cantrip.
Okay.
To go like, yes, this is magical. No, this is not magical. Basically spend some time separating out the magical from the non-magical.
Okay. I don't have that cantrip.
So, yeah, without that, you don't know out of the stuff that you've collected?
Oh, I do have it. I just don't have it prepared right now. So, can I change my preparations?
You can in the morning.
Okay. So, tomorrow I'll work on that.
Ah, no worries. I'll put it back in the bag for tonight, then.
Oh, I keep them. Yeah. I'm keeping the mirror on me.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
All right. So, who is on second watch?
I don't mind taking that.
I think Snow Maple would usually take first watch.
So Snow Maple's on first watch. Moot Pint's on second.
Sounds good.
I imagine Hall's on last, since he's cooking.
That reminds you, actually. Give me a cooking roll, a survival roll, I guess.
Right.
Oh.
Jeez.
Oh, that's interesting.
Don't know if I have hero points left. You used one, right?
Yep.
Mine's showing three. That seems a lot.
You should use one.
Yeah. Because you get one every hour, so.
I got you. Yeah, I might as well hero point that. And it did take away the hero point, so.
Yeah. All right. So 21. All right. So you do not critically fail and give everybody food poisoning.
That's probably good.
Second one for everybody. That'd be bad. All right. Moot Pint. As you're kind of settling in, you're playing with your mirror, not really paying all that much attention to being on watch. But you can give me a perception roll.
Right.
Was that a basic meal?
Yep, basic meal.
All right, so that'll take 10 of our ingredients.
Gonna have to start hunting soon, right?
I pulled in some basic ingredients today, so we're at 14 now.
Okay, not bad.
Ooh, an 18. So, Moot Point, as you're playing at the mirror, you do hear something large moving through the grasslands around you.
Okay. That could be a lot of different things. That could be lions, tigers, and bears.
Or moose.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
I think I'd see the moose.
Yeah, unfortunately, it is not within the glow of your campfire.
All right. And is it coming towards us?
Seems to be.
All right. What would Moot Point do in a situation like this? He probably would wake up the barbarian. So that's kind of what I'm going to do. What do I want to do? Do I want to wake up the barbarian? That sounds risky. Can I get my monkey familiar to go check it out?
What abilities does your monkey familiar have today?
Land speed, climb speed, low light vision.
Right. So he can go check it out, but he can't actually tell you what it is because he can't talk or telepathically communicate?
It's got climber and speech enabled here.
Oh, okay.
Under effects.
So it's got speech, so it can talk.
Yeah. Okay. Land speed 25, climb speed 25, low light vision, climber, and speech. That's what it's got.
All right.
Spellcasting ability, intelligence.
Okay. All right. So you're like, go, go. He kind of looks at you. Woo. Kind of scampers off into the darkness.
And Father Hall doesn't like monkeys.
Snow Maple doesn't like monkeys.
And Dawn doesn't like monkeys.
That's fair. Snow Maple might not have seen a monkey. She's from the desert after all, but she is a traveler, so hard to say.
So it kind of goes for a couple minutes. And then comes scrambling back fairly quickly.
All right.
And you did definitely hear something large chasing it.
All right, now it's time to wake people up.
One sec. Right. Let's have folks roll some initiative.
Oh, it's go time. Okay.
Well, something, just in time to roll initiative, Flower.
Something is charging into your camp, so the order of actions will matter.
I rolled a 20.
All right.
Well done.
For once.
Can I roll stealth initiative?
You cannot, because you're not hiding.
Damn. Yeah, we're back down to single digits.
Ooh, that is some super good initiative rolls for most of you.
Oh, yeah, it is.
All right. Traxton, you can give me a perception roll.
Awesome. Don't usually hear my name first. I rolled a 12.
All right. So you hear... you hear something large kind of moving towards you guys as you're like asleep. You're like, oh, Gratch, leave me alone. Then you're like, no, that's not Gratch. That's something large out there. So you do hear it.
Okay.
I'm gonna cantrip dancing lights just to give us a little nicer view.
Yep.
What's spread your... the four of them out. It's 120 range.
Yep.
120 feet. So
once your turn comes around.
Okay.
So yeah, this is, sorry, just so I'm clear, this is like I get my three actions or whatever, and yep. I just don't see anything right now?
Correct. Your eyes kind of flutter open. You hear something large moving.
Okay. I think and we're in a circle of camp light, right? Like there's...
Yep.
Or firelight? Okay.
Yep.
So I think the first thing Traxton is going to do is he's going to get real quiet. He's going to get... Gretch to follow him, so I guess support command for now. And the next thing he's going to do is he's going to move out of the camp light, hopefully to get his dark vision to kick in and the rest of his senses try to find out what's out there.
All right.
Or at least get a lock on it for now. So I don't know, maybe move, support, and another check to try and find this thing specifically?
Yes, it is a perception roll.
Okay. And that's my three actions, right?
Yes. You'll have to spend one action to stand up, actually.
Oh, okay. Hmm.
Because you guys are basically asleep.
Okay, so maybe no support then from Gretch, so I'll just move out of the firelight and try to see this thing.
Okay.
Yeah. The tides have turned. I rolled a one, so I'm just staring off into the darkness.
Okay. Alright. Into the darkness.
Yeah. Or sorry, that is like there's no degree on this. Do I think I'm seeing something I don't or
no, you hear something, but you can't tell from where.
Okay, gotcha. Alright.
Snow Maple, perceptional.
Okay.
Oof, you are awake. You hear something coming towards you dangerously close to your tent, actually.
Right. I will attempt to stealth. To remain very still.
Alright. This is a stealth roll.
And maybe stand up?
Yeah, that too.
Alright. So you're going to get to your feet. You're going to like be very, very still. Hoping that whatever is out there does not notice you.
Yeah.
Okay. You want to draw a weapon or anything? Or?
No, I'm good.
Oh yeah, you've got quick draw anyway. Father Leon.
I think that's three things, though, isn't it? Perception, and stealth.
The perception roll to wake up is free.
Okay. In that case, I will move half my speed away from the campfire and then stealth.
Okay.
And not towards the monster.
Kind of out into the darkness?
Yeah.
Okay. Father Liam, perception roll.
Okay.
All right. So yes, you also hear a noise, something large coming towards your camp.
I did not cast instant armor, which I should have. He's going to stand. He'll grab his shield. Is raising the alarm like a free action, or is that an action?
It would be an action. It's an action called call out or point out or whatever it's called.
Crap.
Like, you can yell, but it's the difference between you yelling and you yelling and, like, kicking flower in the head sort of thing.
Yeah, he'll spend his third action to kick flower in the head. Get up, get up.
Okay, All right, so Flower does not have to make the perception roll. He automatically wakes up. That will take us to Moot Point.
Yeah, I'm incoming. Everybody up. And I'm casting the shield on myself and the dancing lights to give us a little bit of view. Didn't go 120 feet away from me, so towards where that monster, whatever the thing is coming at us, is.
All right. So yeah, so as these lights kind of like explode out into the darkness, you can see this large, furry, beaked creature.
Owlbear. This ain't gonna be fun. Last action, I'll notch a bolt into the crossbow.
Okay. The owlbear. Goes galumphing towards the one person it can see.
The monkey?
No, it was chasing the monkey. The monkey is like skittered around behind you.
It's a good spot for it.
Oh, the monkey. Oh, the betrayal.
Silly monkeys.
And it is going to let out a blood-curdling screech.
My blood is curdled.
So everybody within an 80-foot emanation, which is everybody, needs to make a will save.
I rolled a 9.
Okay.
Oh, my will save's not bad. It's my fortitude that sucks.
All right. So Moot Point is frightened too. Traxton is frightened too.
What's the DC?
20.
Oh shit, I just made it then.
Father Hall is frightened too. Snow Maple succeeded and is only frightened 1.
Okay.
Only. So yeah, so this thing like barges into the camp, lets out this screech, and it's like scares the shit out of all of you. Because that is a that is an owlbear.
Hoot hoot, motherfucker.
Flower, you've been kicked in the head, and now you're like, you wake up at this thing, and you're like this thing, like, you've heard of owlbears. Like, owlbears have like destroyed members of your clan. You are very, very frightened of this thing.
This is bad news. So frightened, is it the kind of, is it just like in D&D, or is it...
It is not, actually.
What does that entail?
So, frightened basically means you take a penalty on a shitload of things. Basically, all of your checks and all of your DCs is reduced by your frightened condition.
Yeah.
That includes your armor class, everything. But at the end of each of your turns, your frightened condition decreases by 1.
Okay. So where it's 2 right now, it'd be 1, then none.
Exactly. Frightened goes away over time.
Okay, cool. It's like you're stealing yourself.
Exactly.
Time.
Yeah. But it does. It is a minus, currently minus two penalty on all of your attacks, all of your saving throws, all of your checks, and all of your difficulty class, including AC.
Hmm. Well, I'm going to do what Flower does best. Second. I'm just gonna read something. Okay. I'm going to try to get in on it and attack it.
Okay. So it is an action to get up.
I don't have my macro because I don't have a token on the board.
Really? Because I'm looking right at Flower.
I can't see it. Hold on, let me refresh real quick.
Okay.
I don't see a Flower. I see everyone else.
I see Flower right there.
Interesting.
Yeah, I don't see Flower.
Nor I.
Okay, give me a sec here. Might be a vision thing. Because I know I have to play around with the vision for the iPad, so...
Yeah.
Let me just, like...
I'm looking at the... The wider map.
Yep.
That would be why. See, it's better when I actually activate the right scene.
There we go. Now I can see.
That's a different thing altogether.
That is a different thing altogether.
So, okay, so action to get up. We're just going to sudden charge.
Okay. Wonder if I make it darkness if. Work now. Alright. So just as a reminder, because you were asleep, you don't have your weapon ready.
That's right. So instead of sudden charge, I'll gently walk over to it and draw my weapon.
Okay. And that will take us around to Traxton.
All right.
Are these wispy things also on the map, Chris?
Yep, those are the dancing lights.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Let's do some hunted prey.
Okay.
Also, I think for this very moment, he's going to use an action to draw out his longbow.
All right.
And one action to shoot this thing and not move anywhere. Is that doable?
Yep.
Oh, I rolled a 17.
That will hit.
Excellent. And the longbow is a D10, isn't it?
One sec here.
Okay.
Hero points for people. Yes, I believe it is a D10.
Okay, and I add strength bonus. Do I add full strength or just two?
Half your strength. So half. Two. Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay. Damage incoming. one on dice, so three.
Wants to get some damage on target, but also keep it low key.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So yeah, so the arrow sinks into it. I mean, you're a little bit shaky because you're afraid, and longbows have a thing called volley, so if you shoot within a certain range, there's a penalty. So you're going to want to like back up a little bit, get a little bit more distance to more effectively use the longbow, but still on target, so.
Oh, okay. Didn't know what volley was. Gotcha. Yep.
Volley basically means if you shoot at a target within 30 feet of you, there's a penalty.
Gotcha. Seeing it.
If you back up like 30, like 5 feet or so, you'll be fine. Snow people! You have ducked off into the darkness. You've heard the growls. What would you like to do?
Am I hidden with the stealth action that I took?
You think so, but you're not sure.
Okay. There's flower, and that's... Oh, moot pint. That's a bad place for you.
No kidding.
Yeah, it's so bad.
I ain't gonna be there long.
Well, we'll get out the short sword and give it a... Or not short sword, short bow.
Okay.
And give that a try. Really? 17's a miss. Alright, 17 is a miss. We'll spend a hero point.
Okay.
Nope. Alright.
So yeah, two arrows fly over this thing.
Just the one.
Just the one. Oh yeah, I suppose. Hero point.
I'll get behind the tent and try and do another stealth.
Okay. That will take us to Father Liam.
Oh, Father Liam's not in a great spot.
I think he's in the tent still.
He's got a shield. He does not have his armor, but he's standing up. Let's see. We're going to... Oh, this seems to be working, so we're going to keep doing this. Got to move here as a stride. And he's going to cast Magic Weapon on Flower. Because I memorized too.
Excellent.
That's him, I think.
All right. That will take us to Moot Pie.
Moot Pie wants to move. Kind of behind Gratch there.
Okay. Gratch just looks at you like, what the hell?
And I'll fire off the crossbow.
Okay.
And I will put shield back on again.
Okay.
Is this going to handle all the math here for me?
Yeah, as long as you target it. And then under strikes, choose your crossbow.
Doesn't have it. Where is it? It's gone.
Should be the top thing under your...
And I'll have to reload next round. Moot point.
Yeah. That is a miss.
Moot point for moot point.
Okay. The owlbear. Well, now flowers right there.
Ento.
Shoot, I should have done another medicine to patch you up.
Yeah, especially because he did not have time to put his armor on.
Oh. So
it is going to rake you with its talons.
Armor wouldn't have mattered on that one.
And then it is going to use its second action to grab. And then it is going to gnaw.
Oh, that's not good.
I'm so glad I moved.
I bet.
So
I got you, Flower.
So it tries to disembowel you with its beak. So I need you to make a DC 22 will save.
Oof.
Good God.
Ooh, not a critical failure. So you are sickened one and slowed one. Basically, it like rips into your entrails and you can feel like the poison from your gut starting to spread through your system.
Ugh.
Oh, Flower's got to get a new cloak out of this one.
Flower, you are up. So because you were slowed, at the start of your turn, you lose one of your actions. So you only have two actions. You are currently grabbed, so you are immobilized. You are sickened, which gives you a penalty on a ton of things, and you are still frightened.
Well, I'm going to do what I do best. I'm going to try to hit it.
All right.
Not as confident as he was last time.
You can do it.
19 is a miss.
Oh.
Hero point it.
Hero point.
Okay.
Just to see what happens.
Oop.
Yeah, there's flower rolls today.
Yep.
We'll try to hit it again.
Okay.
The backswing.
Oh, that is a
hit.
There we go.
Get out of here.
Okay. So yeah, so it's like grabbed you with the talons and like tears open your stomach with its beak. You swing that thing and it just kind of like shakes its head and then like kind of like growl screeches at you.
Heck beast.
That will take us to Traxton.
Kaka kaka tookie tookie.
All right. Going to move. Also going to draw my long sword.
Okay.
I'm going to get... Actually... No. No movement for Gratch this turn. I will also use the last action to pull out the short sword.
Okay.
And that'll be my turn.
All right. Just kind of dropping your bow where you were.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, sorry.
Okay. Perfect. Snow Maple,
Do you got flower, Father Liam?
Yep.
All right. I am gonna step out from cover. And take a shot at the elder.
Okay. And as you do, it kind of whips its head around in that direction.
Oh, so I wasn't stealthed.
You are not stealthed.
Oh, good.
Fucking owls.
They got big eyes.
But a 21 is a hit.
They turn their head so weird.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I don't have to worry about stealth anymore. For my third action, I'm gonna ready the dueling cape.
All right. And that will take us to Father Liam.
Father Liam, without his armor, is not very happy with this whole situation. I'm going to drop a 2-action heal on Flower.
Okay.
Because that's what we do. And for my third action, what do I want to do for my third action? I think I'm going to raise my shield.
Okay. That will
seems like where a support guy should be.
Yeah. That will take us to Moot Point.
I'm going to hit it with a hydraulic push. It says here heightened plus one. Does that mean just add, take one extra cast time?
No. If it was a spell that you actually knew, you could learn it at level 2 to have a bigger effect.
Oh, okay. So I'm going to just, yeah, attack with that, and I'm going to cast shield on myself again.
Okay.
Everything's on here. This is going to do all the math for me, right?
Yep, just target it and choose hydraulic push. Oh, that is a hit. Ooh, 14 damage is decent.
Yeah.
And it seems to me I think it gets pushed as well.
Yep, 5 feet.
So 5 feet. Perfect. All right. And then you cast shield on yourself. Okay.
Yeah.
Lights go out because they weren't sustained.
Yeah, those are gone.
Okay. The owlbear kind of like shakes its head.
Kind of faded out on me there, Chris.
Yep, that's okay. I'm just figuring out what the owlbear is doing.
Okay. My staff says it's got 2 charges left. That ain't good.
Oh, that's getting close.
So, it is going to try to bite Flower.
Does the hydraulic push break the grapple and all that?
The grapple goes away at the start of the creature's turn.
Oh, okay.
Oh my god.
Jeepers.
Holy crap.
Ouchie.
And then it is also going to lash out with a talon.
Oh. Oh no.
Oh, good lord.
Night.
This is like Godzilla.
Alright, so yeah, as this thing kind of stomps forward and it just lashes out and it like guts Flower. Flower is down and is actually at dying too because it was a crit that dropped him.
Uh-oh.
And that will take us... Actually, no, sorry, it does not take us to Flower because the initiative changes. Basically, Flower moves to just before the owlbear, giving you guys a chance to do things before he has to make any recovery rolls. That will take us to Traxton.
Okay. I will move to this space, get some support, and try and do a twin takedown because this guy is already hunted. First roll is a 15.
That is actually a critical hit. Oh, wait, sorry. Apparently I had... For some reason I had Flower. I thought I had... But it is a hit.
Okay. And the next is a 16.
Both hits.
Perfect. All right. First hit. Well, I roll all the damage together, but...
Yeah.
So... 10. So 10 for the first strike on dice.
Okay.
And for the second... 11 on the dice.
All right. So yeah, so you kind of like run up this thing and drive both of those swords into it as Gratch harries it from behind. It is looking pretty badly injured now at this point.
Okay. Yeah, I see what did to Flower. I'm like, no.
Yeah. Snow Maple.
Right. I think it's time for me to jump in and play Battle Medicine.
Everyone's favorite game.
Eight is alive.
Eight is alive.
Can I use my action to drag him back from the owlbear? Or my last one?
You can drag him 5 feet.
Alright, I will drag him directly between Father Liam and me.
Gotcha. Alright. That will take us to Father Liam.
Oh, this is so bad.
If you don't
want to
stream it.
Do you want me to heal or do you want me to take fire?
I mean, do what you gotta do.
Just as a note mechanically, because Flower is at wounded one, So if he drops again with his 8 hit points, he goes to wounded 2. But if it's a crit that drops him, he'll go to wounded 3. So a crit won't kill him outright, but it is dangerously close.
That doesn't help.
I think a little, actually.
Oh, God, I don't know. I mean, we got to heal him, right?
Of course we
do. I'm going to give him a heal.
He's not dying. But,
Well, it's heal him or get in the way.
Yeah, and those are both good things.
I don't have any armor on.
Yeah, that's a bad thing.
No one does.
Okay, fuck it. I'm going in.
Okay.
I'm going to step.
Okay.
I'm going to trip.
Okay. For some reason, but a 15 will not be enough.
I had flower targeted, sorry.
Yep, that's okay. But a 15 round, 15 is still not enough.
Oh, it's agile too. Okay.
Well, you want to go?
That's what recall knowledge is for.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're busy.
I really got to remember to use that more often.
I will last action raise my shield.
All right. That will take us to Moot Point.
I will use my last charge of hydraulic push.
Okay.
These charges come back?
When you prepare in the morning.
Can I use a hero point reroll that?
Sure can. If you right click on the 16, you should get a little drop down menu, and one of them should be reroll with hero point.
Ah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, what else do I got? I can't use magic missile again, right?
If you have another one memorized, you can, but otherwise no.
I only had the one memorized and used it.
Actually, you could drain your imbued item to cast magic missile, but it would be a single missile.
That's not... Can I use that for hideous laughter? Will that work on a beast?
You can, actually.
Well, let's try that. One living creature. It needs to make a will save.
It smokes.
Jesus.
So it will succeed.
It's fucking dead. So oh my god.
It's almost dead.
But it does kind of chuckle, and it can't use any reactions. Alright, Flower.
E.
Look at all of those effects on poor Flower.
Well, he is no longer grabbed, so there's that.
Hey, big guy. maybe just take it easy for a little bit. Unless you got something to throw at that thing.
Oh, I do. Going to draw a giant spear. Hey. I'm going to yeet it.
Might as well stand up first.
No, stand up.
All right. If you stand up and draw it, then you can't throw it because you're slowed.
Oh.
Ah! I'll use a balance on it for this turn, then.
Okay.
I just didn't want you to waste it, that's all.
The owlbear.
Oh, no.
goes running off into the darkness.
Fucking wimp. Get back here.
Basically the wounds that Traxxon inflicted on it between Traxxon and Gratch, it's fleeing.
How far does it get?
75 feet.
Beast is Ooh, it's coward.
Speedy.
But that will take us to Traxxon.
All right. Flowers back on his feet again.
The hunter becomes the prey.
That is...
Traxxon will actually follow behind for two... Well, actually, it's 75 feet out right now, you said?
Yep. So, super important thing to note is if you don't have dark vision without a light source, you cannot see.
Okay. I do actually have the dark visions.
Do you have dark or low light?
I have dark vision. My background gives me low light, and then the elf thing says if I had low light, I get dark vision.
Perfect. I will note that on your character sheet, then. That'll make a difference.
Oh, bloody, okay. Bloody half-elven cheaters.
That's important.
Yeah. Listen, if I wasn't raised in the woods, I wouldn't see in the dark, but it's fine. The idea is I'm going to run... in the direction for two actions. And I just want to make sure this thing, well, my intent for the round is making sure this thing is just getting the hell away from us and not just like clever girl circling around to come at us from a different direction.
Got you. Yeah, give me a nature roll.
Okay. Not horrible. I rolled a 10.
As it kind of lumbers off and it's like it's bolting, but yeah, it, as a beast, like it probably came by looking for an easy meal,
right?
And is now realizing that it is not worth the effort.
Gotcha. Okay. Perfect. He'll just stop then. That'll be his round of actions.
Okay. Snow Maple.
I'll activate my wayfinder.
Okay.
Cause it can do light.
Alright.
And I will chase after the beast for two actions. Give me a speed of 80.
Oof.
Okay. You can catch up with it if you like, but it will take all of your actions to get there.
Yeah, I don't want to catch up with it, but I would like to parallel it, at least.
Alright. How close to it are you getting?
I would prefer to stay slightly behind it, if possible, and off to the side.
So, how far from it are you staying?
Maybe something like, 30 feet.
Okay. So you're staying about 20 feet from it.
Yeah.
All right. That will take us to Father Liam.
The light was clutch, though. Liam's gonna stride.
Okay.
I mean, flower needs fixed, but we'll get to him in a minute. That puts me within range of Electric Arc. Which I think is my most damaging spell.
Electric Arc's a good one.
Right, Divine Lance, Disrupt Undead.
Divine Lance only affects things within alignment.
Yeah, that's all I got. So, Electric Arc, try to kill this thing before it can get away. DC 18 for 8 damage.
Critical success, so no damage.
Ouch.
Fix your heart.
That will take us to Moot Point.
I will load my crossbow, fire my crossbow, and then load my crossbow again.
Okay. That is a miss.
Can I hero point that one too? How many hero points do I have?
Should be on your character sheet.
Uh, 13
is still a miss.
Oh well, it's the same thing as last time.
Alright, Flower.
Flower, I think, just yells out, just typical beast running just when it gets good. I could take you, and then he's leaning on his spear. I think he just kind of falls backwards.
Yeah. you can use an action to basically try to retch up the sickness and try to rid yourself of it.
Sure, I'll do that.
Okay, so
before falling back.
So it's a fortitude save.
Yeah, I'm good at those. My best save.
Bleh. 20 is not enough.
Apu.
Sniper.
I think he just falls back at this point. Actually, I still have actions, eh? Like.
Yep.
You could do it again?
You can.
Cool.
Terrible.
There you go. So yeah, so you're back there just kind of trying to clear this stuff out of your system. And it gets rid of the slowed as well, because you're only sickened, slowed as long as you're sickened.
Perfect. It just falls backwards, just flat out.
Well, this thing was trying to run away, but people keep harrying it.
Oh no. Yeah.
At least it wasn't a critical.
How that oh God.
That one is.
Alright. So yeah, it seems like as the electricity kind of cascades around it, it kind of lets out this screech and then turns, and it's just this maddened anger in its eyes. That will take us to Traxton.
Kill it.
All right, I was gonna be fine with watching it run away, but hey, let's go ahead and finish it off, I guess.
I think it's a danger to anybody it encounters, pal.
I don't think it'd be attacking anybody with a fire anytime soon.
Flowered into the cloak.
Anyway, does that do flanking for me or?
Yes.
Okay.
We had a fire right here.
I don't think I took it into advantage next time. Yeah, but if we let it run away, it knows what happens when it fucks with things that have fire. But anyway. I'll
mount its head above my chain.
I will go ahead, and this is still hunted prey, so yep. I will go ahead and support from Gretch, and I will do twin takedown.
All right.
First roll is a nat 20.
That is a critical.
Second roll is...
Good stuff.
Second roll is a 3, so that probably is no good for anything. I'll hero point, though.
Okay.
Pretty sure I got another one left. That 3 turns into a 14.
Team's not going to do it.
Not good enough to make it. Okay. That's only on the dice. That's not my total.
Yeah. Okay. 14 just barely a miss.
Got it. All right. Crit coming in. 2d4. 48, really.
Yep. 48 plus 6.
Okay. So 11.
Big money, no whammies.
Yeah, it actually is pretty good. 11, 18, and 24 on dice.
Oof.
48. Oof.
No, the 24 is totaled.
Yeah, I rolled all the dice.
24 plus 6, so 30 damage altogether. Yeah. But, so yeah, Traxton, as this thing kind of turns, comes back towards Father Liam, you know, it was trying to get away, but... You know, being chased and electrified and everything, it kind of like snaps and loses it, and just like turns around, and almost eviscerates him. But it leaves its back and its flank open for you and Gratch, and you can dispatch this creature and put it out of its misery.
Yeah, right up through the rib cage with the long sword, I think, and it just end it.
So medic,
come, coming
east.
Seventeen.
That's another critical success on your healing.
Yeah. Healing like a champ. Now that we're out of combat, can I do another regular battle medicine on Flower?
You can do a treat wounds on Flower.
Right. Well, that's 8 more.
Flower is out cold on the ground.
More importantly, though, it gets rid of the wounded condition.
Yeah. Right. Snow Maple will just come and patch you up a little bit and pat you on the shoulder and just be like, "You got him, champ."
Like a little bit of like a
hee. I'll drop a 2-action heal on Flower.
While everybody's getting healed up, I'm just going to pull out my other short sword and take a few talons and feathers.
Okay.
I'm going to make sure the mirror's okay.
The mirror is fine, but when you're looking at it... It's like, huh. For the briefest of moments... For the briefest of moments, as you kind of glance at the mirror to make sure it's okay... you catch something kind of looking back at you that just kind of like ducks out of frame.
Whoa.
But on that note, we will call it there.
He's shy.
Doesn't want to meet you just yet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The only thing that you caught a moot point was just like stunningly beautiful green eyes.
I like it already.
Oh, that's somehow worse.
Right. But everybody does get... let's see. 200 XP.
X372 is what
I... Are we keeping everybody even, or will Professor be behind some?
No, I keep everybody even.
Alrighty.
But yes, just so you guys are aware, at your level now currently, the single owlbear was a low difficulty encounter.
No, it was not.
Wait, what?
No way.
Yep. I mean, it doesn't take into account the fact, like, you know, nobody had armor on and all that fun stuff. But yeah. Yeah. An owlbear is a level 4 creature, so a single one of them against this party is a low difficulty encounter.
Yeah, everything's low good, low difficulty until it hits you.
Yeah.
You start with an ambush, right?
Yep, and that's the thing. Like, if you don't have a chance for your armor, like didn't Father Liam pick up instant armor?
He did. I didn't cast it.
Yeah.
I've got it now, but
before you go to bed, just in case.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. But we will see everybody in a couple of weeks.
All right.
Alrighty. Thanks, Chris.
Cheers.
Always meet you, Renna.
Yep. Have a good evening, folks.
Oh, is there anything we can salvage from the owlbear?
You can grab like some feathers and stuff like that. Actual salvage, you'll need to take some time to basically, like, you'll need to take time in the morning when there's light. So we'll deal with that at the start of next session.
Yeah, definitely interested in that.
All right, I'll make note of it.
Perfect.
Cool.
All right, have a good note, folks.
Okay.